Welcome to another episode of Peas Elite This.
Hold on. I can't.
Go ahead, man.
When good stuff happens at Warwick.
Let's start there. Should be a short list.
This is just some good stuff that happens, right?
The planes land and they take off.
Ha! Airport. Boom. Numero uno. Anything else?
It's a couple of malls, maybe?
Ish.
No.
No, not really.
Just one. Just one mall.
The other ones come up, though. They put some stuff in there.
Which one?
The Rhode Island Mall. They don't call it that no more.
Rhode Island Mall is not there. It's a Burlington.
Yeah, it's like stores now.
It's a furniture store, if I'm not mistaken.
No, there's other stuff there besides the furniture store. There's like Burlington, there's the furniture store, there's Walmart. Yeah. There's Kohl's.
But we don't call that Rhode Island Mall.
That's what I'm saying. They don't call it that no more. It's just stores now, but it's come up. There's the At Home that's got some stuff in there. They got the Wendy's still that somehow has lived through all this.
It's like
Dick's is over there.
Dick's? A whole bunch of big box white people stores.
Grow up, Bim. Grow up.
And the Glizzy's.
The Glizzy's is over there.
They're doing something to Toys R Us. I don't know what they're doing. They painted.
Oh, yeah, doing something over there. It's going to be at BJ's.
Is it?
Dick's and BJ's in the same place.
Episode 74.
This is what happens when we get back together, ladies and gentlemen. How amazing was that? Welcome to another episode of your favorite podcast. Please lead this.
You can't make this stuff up, guys.
In the basement, we have Darren.
Damn.
Genevieve.
We are back together.
Yeah. Darren, that was brilliant, bro. Damn.
Dicks and BJ's.
Warwick's popping, yo.
See, you said what positive things happen in Warwick.
I was wrong. I was so wrong. You kidding me? Anything you need. All right, sure.
What more do you need?
Man.
Oh, dear.
What's happening?
Not much, man. It is nice to have you back.
Nice to be back-ish.
Mm. I'm sure it's not that nice to be
back. It's cold, man. Mm. So cold here. But I'm happy to see you guys. Yeah. Honestly. And thank you for recording still. Mm. Progress. 100 episodes ago. Jen would have just said, no, let's just not record.
Nope.
For
2 weeks. We'll take 2 weeks off.
Yeah. It made
so
me
we
happy.
Did it. Shout out to Scarlett and Darling for joining us.
You forget?
He did. You've seen that, right? Wow. I can't wait till he hears that.
I didn't. Come on. It's not like I was like, oh, who was it?
Kind of, a little bit.
You had to snap.
Yeah, and close your eyes and everything.
Mm. Yeah, because I had to channel Darling's seat here. Mm. And you know. Whatever.
What's up? No, but thank you, Scarlett. Yes. Scarlett, I didn't forget. I heard you. You sounded great. That's 2 in a row. No, actually 3. She's done 3 podcasts. Mm-hmm. Start yours. Do it. You're funny as hell. You got a lot going on in your life. Wow. Way to make it vivid as well. So you have a gift. Q, my brother, I'm mad I wasn't here. You got to come back. We got to do one together. Yes. Thank you, guys. Splendid. Well done.
You listen to them?
I listen to both, yeah. Hmm. I wasn't supposed to?
I mean, you know, I'm just like, wow.
Well, because you know why I tuned into the first one. I was hoping for an in-depth review of the Ye interview.
No.
And I did not get that.
You did not get that. Not at all.
Not even. I was like, did I listen to the same interview they did?
That wasn't happening.
No. And
not without you.
I have to say this. My friend Darren, he is so cute when he's talking hip hop. It is so adorable. It is so adorbs.
Did you hear when he tried to bring up sports?
Oh, man.
Oh, my God. It was so cute.
For you,
man.
It was good, though.
It was for you.
Oh, that was nice.
Amazing. But I had a couple of points. Hold on.
Like, I know Bim took notes.
Come on. This is me, man.
This is
me.
My friend.
Hold on now. I had to.
I was going to say, you ain't got to still do that.
No, I didn't.
We grown.
Oh, the tap? This is a thing. Mm. Like something bad might happen. Notes. Episode 172. Mm.
Wait, what number is this one? Did we do that?
Yep. This is 4.
174.
Right? Mm-hmm. So, the tour, the college tours.
Yes.
Congrats to Lexi. How you feeling? You feeling a little better about the process?
Yeah. I'm just on board whatever she wants.
God bless. God bless.
I kind of had a review with Clarabelle. She's a high school teacher, mm-hmm. a guidance counselor, and that has been doing this forever, so she knows all the ins and outs of college, and she kind of just gave me a quick rundown of kind of where Lexi stands academically, and it's very impressive, to say the least.
Very dope. And is that, actually, no, yeah, good is good, no matter.
I mean, she's, like, top 50 in her class.
Ooh.
Her GPA is, like.
Should be a scholarship involved then.
Yeah, so she basically was, like, Lexi's not going to have a problem getting into a school. It's going to be which school she wants to go to.
Oof. Amazing.
So, yeah.
So, in terms of that, you had mentioned one of her top picks was Georgetown.
Yes.
To which Jen then mentioned
Patrick Ewing.
And I scratched my head.
Why?
And I said, is she so old? Is she so old? That Patrick Ewing, that entered the NBA in the 80s, was her reference for Georgetown. Have you forgotten Allen Iverson?
This is good. You're nice and smooth.
Have you forgotten Allen Iverson?
Never would have even connected those two things.
Allen Iverson and Georgetown?
I will say, Patrick does stand out a bit more than Allen. Okay, listen, I'm not saying that one is better than the other. I'm just saying if you were to say
if
to
you
me...
you say Georgetown and you're playing word association?
Patrick Ewing.
Patrick Ewing.
It's just because he's just... Wait,
how old are you guys again?
70.
This is Allen Iverson who changed the NBA.
I understand
tattoos,
that.
Braids,
yes.
Shorts. He came from Georgetown.
Patrick is a big... oaf of a man somewhat.
And you stopped watching the NBA.
When did we have? Okay.
That one took me out. So Patrick Ewing. And you guys stayed on Ewing for a while. Totally fine. Oh, yeah, and that was Scarlett's episode, right?
No.
Oh, no, that was
Q's
episode.
His name.
No, I thought it was Scarlett on that one. So the Gorilla Glue song, was that?
That was the Gorilla
Q's
Glue
episode or Scarlett's episode? Okay, so I mixed my notes. It's fine. So, Ye Talk. There were a couple of things. We won't stay on this long. But during the interview, I did learn something. Damien Hirst, is that name familiar to you guys?
No.
He was talking about artists that he introduced to Drake, and one of them was Damien Hirst. And that's what led to Drake's album cover. So remember we were making fun of the emojis that he had and whatnot? So I'm going to show you guys a Damien Hirst painting. And you can see exactly where the influence came from. But outside of that, I got a lot from that interview. Like in terms of, because all right, we know Ye is going to, he has no filter, right? He's just going to say what he's got to say. But outside of the issues that people have with what he says, some of it was pretty brilliant.
And that's like, what I be trying to tell people. Like, if you understand what he says.
You see the dots?
Yeah.
It's not as.
No, that's fine.
Shocking as the initial statement that he makes.
Right.
He'll make a statement, but then when he explains what he means, it's like, okay, I might not agree with it, but I understand where you were going with that.
Right. Real quick, this is the Damien Hirst painting. So those dots that are sorted, they just turn the dots.
They sell blankets like that at Target.
Yes, they do. And this is this is also the candies we had as a kid that you take off and the little dots. But that art inspired the album cover. So as much as we were just like, man, that's lazy, there was actually something behind it. So a bit of culture that we're not privy to, it was a little deeper. You know what I'm saying? One thing that struck me that Ye said, of many, when he was talking about what he wanted to do in terms of like children that people don't want. You didn't get to watch the whole thing, right? Mm-mm. So he's talking about abortions. Now, he didn't say he's anti-abortion, but he was talking about setting up a shelter or somewhere to, for these children to come. Because as these children, well, there's a debate on if it's a life or not, but we don't know what that life could
potential,
have been.
Yeah.
Right? So he's like, no, just, I want something where you could just bring them.
But don't we already have that, like in group homes and stuff? And the initial thought behind those institutions probably came from good, but unfortunately, the execution is difficult because you have to have actual people to run them and money.
And a lot of it is money. Greed takes away from the programs and what can actually go into it. And with him being, what he said, $9 billion up or whatever, he has resources to at least get this stuff started. So he actually cares. And he was really talking about our communities, right, where you have a Planned Parenthood where that's like, oh, that's the first option. Versus some of these other neighborhoods where, no, we got grandmas, we got this, we got this other stuff, where we, if you're in trouble and you don't think you could take care of the child, you have these other options. Whereas in certain neighborhoods, like, scoop it, get out of here. So I dug that.
Scoop it.
Sorry.
Wow.
And then this is the last thing with that. He was talking about music, the actual sound and what it can do to your mind frame. So Ye has always talked about how he doesn't like the topics in our music sometimes. Graduation, killing some whack shit, unless niggas is rapping. He's not a fan of that. So he was talking about 808s and what some of the music sounds like. Remember I was talking about the New York drill scene and how it makes me feel like doing violent things? It's because of those deep, deep drums versus like a West Coast sound, where it's like, oh man, I can see the palm trees, like I can feel like I want to be in a lowrider. So like lower frequency music, and again, this is his brain just taking this information and like he can see the result of it. So like it was a lot of stuff in there that I was kind of taking that wasn't the clickbait articles
right.
that people could take that really had me like, yo, nah, people are missing some like real stuff that he's talking about.
I'm glad I'm not the only one now. Cause I'm like, when I say that stuff, I'm like, I feel like I sound crazy.
Not at all. Not Thank at all. You. When you were saying it in the Gemini thing, I was like, no girl, it's not just a Gemini thing. I'm with you, boo. I was right here. I was right here. But, okay, episode 173 now. I got to do my notes, guys. Scarlett, amazing, by the way. The Carter Experience.
Hilarious.
Man.
Listen.
Man. Man, listen. Oh, man.
The way I almost fell out this chair.
Amazing.
He said, you're not watching my kid, right?
I counted. I think it was six times you said that. At least six.
He was like, just to make sure.
Just, I want you to be well aware.
And Scarlett was trying to round it up. All day. Yeah, by the way, that's cool. Never.
Never.
Like, I'm not joking. You this is not my serious face.
Oh, my God. It's funny that she said that she got her glasses from Zillow. I didn't know they sold glasses, too. That's amazing.
Zillow. Zenny? Zillow. Okay.
Incredible. Lost right in the beginning of the episode. Scarlett is a godsend. A gem, if you will. And the Gorilla Hair Glue song, Jen.
Yes.
How in Baby Jesus' name does one find such a thing? Is it because you follow her?
No, he brought it up.
Who? Because you follow her on Instagram, right?
No.
I follow Instagram, but he brought up the song. I hadn't heard
it.
So you follow her, but you found it.
I found it.
How?
I was scrolling through TMZ's website.
Why are you doing that?
I was looking
he
for...
He wants to know who again, died today.
No, listen, I want to know who... Damn, Jen.
So, he was probably looking for that
Wyclef
thing.
I was looking for the Wyclef thing, and then I saw another headline. I was like, oh, that might be interesting to talk about. And then I saw that, and I was like, I wonder if Jen knows about this.
And I actually didn't. But then, like, the next day, or the day after that, I go on, and then, you know, because, like you said, I follow her. And it's a video that she posted. Her split, no, actually, it wasn't even her. It was Angela from Angela and Michael.
What is
from
that?
90 Day Fiancé.
Oh, okay.
Nigerian Michael.
Michael?
And Angela. I think they split now, but.
No way.
Oh, no.
Yeah, but Angela done got all this plastic surgery and lost all this weight and all this stuff.
No!
Yeah. So she's she's got a split screen.
Darren looking for now.
Of her and the Gorilla Glue lady singing the song.
Stop.
And she's got a slick ponytail. So I put it on our story. I don't know if you guys seen it. But
I did not see it.
I was like, cool. This goes from bad to wow.
Bad to wow.
This is like.
Yeah, the song is very bad.
It's very terrible.
It's very bad.
It's very bad.
And then also, last from that episode, you guys were like kind of kink shaming a little bit, yo.
In which part?
The peeing on people?
Yeah. I mean, hey, okay. I don't do that. But it's a very normal thing. Very normal thing. I'm not saying everybody does it, but it's been around for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, different strokes, you know. But one thing that stood out that you guys said in regards to that was how men have, or it's mostly men that have these weird kinks or obsessions or whatever.
Yep.
The feet thing, the peeing thing, the pooping thing is usually guys. Do women have anything like that?
Not that I've heard of in a mainstream kind of way.
I've heard the I can't say the worst, but I've heard men love like dad bodies. Not men. Women love dad bodies.
But that's not so much like a
that's not a king.
Right. But yeah, but it's like I guess it's almost looked at like ew, I can't like I don't know why you'd like that girl and
I don't even think that. I think women, just like men, like real looking people. So you know how guys would be like, oh, we don't need a girl to wear makeup and have fake hair. We just like a natural looking woman.
Yeah.
Same thing with women. We like a guy who just looks like a guy. Like, we just want to, you know what I mean? So when they say we like guys with dad bod, it just means you don't need to have abs or, you know, pecs and all that. You could just be a regular
dude. No, it doesn't look like they split up. I'm sorry to throw that way off. It's according to this weird, the overtimer.com, as of October, they're still together. They're married.
I don't know.
Breaking news
on Instagram, and I don't think they're together. But if overtimer.com says it,
then... check TMZ. But no, good stuff, man. Good stuff. Very enjoyable episodes. Kept me company during the long layovers, for sure. For sure. Appreciate you guys, man. And again, Q, Scarlett, thank you.
Where were you?
Oh, that. Yeah, you guys didn't mention where I was on the thing.
We did once, kind of, a little bit, but not really.
No, no, I never said where you were. Yeah, I didn't want to put your business out there like that.
I put on Instagram.
Yeah, we anyway, go ahead.
All right, so my wife and I, we finally got our honeymoon, and we were off in the Maldives. For those who don't know where the Maldives are, it's southwest of India, located in the Indian Ocean, an assortment of islands and whatnot, and nice luxury villas that are built right on the ocean floor. So yeah, no, we had a lovely trip.
Fantastic. How long were you gone?
So, the story begins.
Here we go.
All right, so we were supposed to be gone for 7 days. We were supposed to leave on Wednesday, and that's why I couldn't record on Thursday. So Wednesday, getting stuff done, we work, we're, you know, kind of running behind. So heading to the airport, and since we were late, I said, okay, I'll drop you off at the gate, shawty. Get us checked in. I'm going to drop the car off because we flew out of Boston. At the parking place, take an Uber to the airport, join you, and we'll be good. Yeah. I drop her off, and it's packed. So I'm like, okay, good thing we did this. So as I'm going to drop the car off, I'm running through a bunch of hoops. I'm like, damn, am I going to miss this flight or be late because they're delaying me over here with this car?
No, home alone ass.
I'm saying. So as I'm there, and shawty calls me, I'm like, damn, she's looking for me. So I'm like, hey, sorry, I'm just trying to wrap up. And she said, oh, don't worry about it. They said we can't get on the flight.
Oh.
I said, huh? She's like, I'll call you back. Now I'm like, what's happening? Because last time I had my issues at the airport, I'm like, is this just following us? Hmm. So she calls me and says, just come back. It's looking like they're not going to let us get on the plane. This doesn't make any sense. What's the problem? We went and got our COVID test.
Yep.
We did everything we had to do. We did the portal thing for Maldives, everything. So I get there, and as you can imagine, she's like frazzled.
Yeah.
And I'm like, just tell me what they said. They said they couldn't accept our COVID test, our PCR test, because it didn't have an address on it of what? Where we, of the lab. I said, huh?
What?
For the Maldives, it was specific for them because each country can have their own stipulations. We're only accepting tests where you can see the lab. I guess a lot of probably fake tests or whatnot avoid that. So we couldn't do anything. And our flight was at 10 o'clock at night. Last one out. So...
What are you just like?
I felt so defeated. So immediately, because my wife is not happy, mm-hmm. my first thought is we need a win right now. We have to get a win to help our spirits, and then we'll go from there. Yeah. She was on the same page. Antonio's, yes, let's go. So we
that's so funny.
Drove back home, got some pizzas. We made it right before they closed, and brainstormed. What are we gonna do? The next day is a holiday. It was Veterans Day. So nothing's open. So it's not like we can get a test. They said we can go to the airport and do another test and pay $500.
What?
For an on-site PCR test. I said, I'm not doing that. So she's on the phone with the guy on the way home. They're saying we'd have to pay the difference in the price of the flight if we get it another time. So I think it was like an additional $1,200 or something like that. I said, I'm not doing that either. Mm. And in my head... After I got over it, like, man, look, I got the days off. I don't care, man. If we got to take this, I will cancel the flight, get our money back and whatever. I don't care. But she was on it, thank God. And in the morning, we were able to call the call center for the testing lab. And she gave the whole spiel. It's our honeymoon, blah, blah, blah. And the lady said, okay, we don't usually do this, but I'm going to send you an email with both of y'all tests with the address. She did it. We called. She was able to cancel the flight and book another flight that was a little bit cheaper that got us there the same time. So we only lost a day. So
okay.
She's a beast with it.
Okay.
So Thursday morning, we woke up wild early, made the calls, had breakfast, and then right back to the airport. So we finally get there. So the journey, very long. We had to fly to Qatar. It took 11 and a half hours to get there. Mm-mm. Then we had a five hour layover in Qatar.
Pause. That sounds like the noise that franchise. You know what? That's what that sounded like.
You're supposed to give me sound effects. I'm sorry.
Oh, I heard that too. No. No sound effects.
I told you.
No sound effects. I told
you. Gotta do it while he's gone.
There's no way. When I'm gone, whatever you want. Do whatever you want. No way. Oh.
potty pooper.
So thankfully we have the priority pass. For folks who don't know what priority pass is, there are lounges in almost every airport where you can go get food. Some of them have napping stations. Some of them have showers. And there are, some of them open 24 hours. So luckily Qatar was. So we were able to go there and just sleep or chill until the next flight. So 6-hour flight then from Qatar. She did it again. 6-hour flight from Qatar to the Maldives. Then in the Maldives, a 45-minute seaplane.
That's where you lose me. That's where you lost me.
A seaplane, and again, for those who don't know what a seaplane is, if you remember Tailspin, it's that yellow plane that Baloo had that lands on the water and takes off on the water. Tailspin. I knew you guys would appreciate that. So, 45-minute seaplane to our destination.
So, it lands on the water.
Lands on the water.
Okay.
Get this.
Oh, more.
I was fine for a little bit. I wasn't fine in the beginning. So, my first time on a seaplane, so... very small, and they had it at capacity, 2 rows and then a single row on the other side, and it's tight and you got everybody's luggage in there. So you can see the two pilots, you're right there, you can tap them on the shoulder if you want, and they have the overhead thing that they move to turn and fly. Cool, I'm excited. We're gonna fly. As they're going, and it's wavy, it's like, okay, it's fine. And then I see the guy grab the thing and start to pull it. I'm like, we about to go up. We start going up, and it starts making this terrible noise. My heart just starts to drop. I said, no, this is not how I go up. So he corrects it, and then and it keeps making the noise as we're going up. It's okay.
No, thank you.
Okay, well, this is it. Then we're fine. The noise stops. Then we're flying into clouds. Mm-hmm. As we're in the clouds, because I'm like, oh, it's a beautiful cloud. It's so nice. We enter the cloud. Oh my God. Okay, so we get past all of that. So now we're going over the islands. We're going over the islands. And it is beautiful. Quick fact, there are over 200 islands in the Maldives, little islands, coral, whatever's. Mm. 180 or so of them have people on them.
Okay.
Including all these different resorts and stuff. So we're dropping people off at their resort.
What, like parachutes? Or you guys...
No, we land upon the water.
Okay. Might as well use a parachute at that point.
No, parachutes would have been much better.
My ass. And because we missed our first day, we didn't have a seaplane scheduled for us to go to our island.
Oh.
So we took a 45-minute seaplane to a different island, and look at how it lands. I saw the island, and we landed maybe 200 yards away from the island. So what's going on? We're on the ocean now. There's a little dock, but just a wooden flat dock. Some guy got out of the seaplane while it was still in motion so that he could jump onto the dock and attach the seaplane to it. This is just floating in the ocean. We get on this thing. It's rocky because a boat came to get us, to bring us to the island.
And a boat.
Right.
A boat.
You would definitely have lost me there.
Yeah.
I don't even like driving to New York, bro. Like, what are you even describing to me?
Yeah, it wasn't fun. So we get to that island. I'm like, oh. And they're like, oh, no, don't worry. Boat's coming for you guys. Me and Drina only.
Wait. Did they, like, get Doc and then, like, take off and be like, all right, you good. We'll be back.
The other people walked away to their beautiful island and their stuff. And we just stood there and waited for our boat. So a speedboat comes.
A speedboat?
Yeah. And they're like, okay, yeah, it'll just be a 45-minute ride to your island now. Oh, I said, 45 again?
You could have just dropped me closer.
It's a parachute. My wife doesn't do well with motion. She gets motion sickness, seasick, all of that. Poor thing.
That sounds like a seasick.
Yeah, me too.
We're on the back of the boat, and she's just... a few times, she was like, doing this. I'm like, oh, my wife. We finally get there, and it is beautiful. The name of the resort we stayed at is You and Me Maldives. Beautiful villas, beautiful weather. The sand. You know how you hate sand? Mm-hmm. You wouldn't hate the sand. Granular, of course, but a little thicker and lighter, if you will.
Oh.
It's on you. Do this. It's gone.
All gone.
It's gone. A little shake of your garment. Gone.
Not your garment.
Your garments. Just is gone. Beautiful. So we make our way to the check-in area, and we give the whole, because our plan was just to tell everybody it's our honeymoon and see what they do for us. So we had a regular villa, and we said, hey, it's the honeymoon. What would it look like to get the dolphin suite? That's the one with the pool.
Yeah.
And they said, ah, you know, we could do it for this price. It was more than half less than if we would have did it online or booked with it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
So they looked out. Yeah. So we stayed, got all set up, got food. The entire stay was beautiful. I'll just say a few things. And I was telling you this earlier, Darren. I brought my camera and taking cell phone pictures. But at some point, it wasn't even worth it. Because you can't capture what you're seeing there. Fish. The water's so clear. You can just see the fish in the water.
That's crazy.
There was a school of fish, thousands of fish, tiny fish, right next to where the water's washing up on shore. Just making their way. Larger fish. I told Darren earlier, I saw a stingray in the water. A little frightening. But you can just see everything. The beach was beautiful. The weather was lovely. The people were super nice. And at night, there was one night where, because we're on the side of the sunset. So we watched the sunset, and then we were walking to dinner. It's still bright out after the sun went down. Mm-hmm. I'm like, why is it so bright? The moon.
Wow.
I've never seen the moon. I'm like cheesing as I'm thinking of it. I've never seen the moon shine so bright that it felt like daylight.
Wow.
And I had to take a picture, but the picture didn't even capture it the way. It was almost like 7:30 or so.
Hmm.
And it was bright out. And I just stood there. I was late for dinner. I just stood there, just looking at it.
That's crazy.
It was incredible.
That's nice.
Yeah, and we also did an H2O dinner, which is about 200 yards away from where we're staying. So still by the island, where you go about 30 meters underwater. And we had a 5-course lunch. And you can just see all the fish and everything underwater. The table they gave us, we had a view of a real shipwreck that was right down there. So a lot of fish and whatnot just swimming through there. The best fish tank you ever seen in your life.
I was telling Darren, the only time I ever heard of the Maldives was on the game show, because they were giving out a trip to Maldives and it was an underwater hotel. And I'm like, I wonder if Bim's going to the underwater hotel.
No,
that's what I saw in your story. It was an underwater restaurant. I was like, yes.
Fire, yeah. Fire. And about 10 minutes before we left the restaurant, because we had the best seats in the house.
Wait, how do you get under there, though? How do you get down there?
They got an elevator and they got stairs. We said, we'll take the stairs. I don't want to get stuck in the elevator.
Oh.
Yeah, no. About 10 minutes before we left, we're just kind of looking at the fish, people taking pictures, and a shark swims by. Now, when I tell you, this is on our resort. So when I say we can just jump in the ocean from the room...
Mm-hmm.
You can see the restaurant right there.
So there's sharks in the water.
Mm-hmm. Mm. So I said, Mom, Madame, Miss, hello, please. What does that thing eat? It's friendly. Don't worry. It just eats plankton.
Mm. It does not.
But, you know, if you're in the water and you see it, you don't want to touch it or do anything.
Yeah. Also, be cautious.
Right.
Because it will kill you.
But this trip was the epitome of relaxation, except for two things that my wife did. Oh, I love you.
Oh, boy.
So, number one.
Oh, boy.
About 2 days into it. So we brought some treats with us because I wanted to relax. Mm-hmm. And, you know, sometimes when you have certain treats, you're chilling. But depending on the treat, there could be some turbulence. Mm-hmm. And you got to work through it, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm sitting there at the bar that has a view of the beach, and I'm just slumped. Because I'm working through my turbulence. And it's quiet. And my wife, God bless her, she just keeps talking to me. And I say, hey, you know, we can figure it out later. Let's just chill. And she just kept talking to me. I said, please, I'm having a hard time. Could you just... I did that too, and it's so rude to do.
It's mad rude. I've been told that's the rudest thing you can do to an adult.
It is, but hey, I'm in paradise. Shh, please, baby, could you just... She started talking again. I said, can you just, you don't hear? You're the only one talking. You're the only one talking.
Poor woman.
Can you just,
poor,
please.
Poor woman.
I couldn't help my state because I needed to level out. You know what I'm saying? So
he's tearing up.
And the same thing happened at the beach. God bless her. I'm on the beach under my umbrella, you know, and it's so quiet. There's people there. There's a lot of people, but I can't have nothing. Not it. Babe?
Oh, man. Ain't nothing breaks the silence worse than that. Babe.
Oh. Second thing I love you. Second thing, we got massages twice, back to back days. Ooh. Oh, did I may have said this before on the podcast. You guys have gotten massages before, right?
Yeah. We ended up getting one on that vacation.
Ooh.
See? It wasn't as fancy like yours. It was.
I need to tell you how we did it.
It doesn't matter.
It was fancy.
It was not fancy, but it was great.
Because massages are great.
It was great.
And I feel like I said it here before, but I'll say it again. So the place we went to, they had like a glass in the ground. So as you put your face down to get the massage, you can see the ocean.
Wow.
That's nice.
And fish going by. Amazing, right? Yeah. We did a lava stone. It's like the hot stone joint. And baby, I did not enjoy this. But the girl, I never had this happen. She's doing the massage thing. She jumped on the table.
Oh.
Like a little monkey. And was just really getting in there. I was like, is she on the table with me? What kind of massage
you
is my
like
wife?
Him. Because we went and it was a guy and a lady, two Asians. And so initially the guy had him and the lady had me. But I think when she saw my back scar, she kind of freaked a little.
Okay.
So she said something to him and then he said something to her.
You almost did something.
And they switched. And so the guy starts talking to me. And he's like, oh, he said something about the scar, whatever. And I'm like, he's like, you had back surgery? I'm like, yeah, it was a long time ago. I'm fine. He's like, you sure? I'm like, yeah. It was like over 20 years ago. I'm fine. Just go ahead. He's like, all right, if you feel any pain, you have to tell me immediately. I'm like, okay, bro. Right. All right.
I get it. I'm an adult.
I'm not going to sue you.
Right.
Just do it. I pay for 60 minutes. Hurry up.
Fam.
And so he had the girl. And at the end, he was like, yo, she put her knees in my butt cheeks, and she was getting in
there. Darren, I was like, yo, this is about to turn into something.
Yo.
I was hype a little. That was hype.
You
got, but I was hype.
You got to ask him about it. It's so funny hearing.
Q, come back, man. We got to talk, man.
Because when she told him, because, you know, we had to turn over.
Mm.
And he was like, yeah, she was like, turn over. I was
I
like.
I can't. I can't.
Not yet.
He's like, she's lucky I was, you know what I mean?
Turn over. Oh, my God.
So, incredible massage. And the kind of massage where in my head I'm thinking, do I know you?
Right.
Have you known me in some life? Because you must love me the way you are just. Because, Darren, if she didn't love me, how did she know?
How did she
where
know?
To touch me?
How?
Tell me. Second day, we go get another massage. 25 minutes, but it was free. Oh, we'll take it.
Oh, hell yeah, I'll take a free 25 minutes.
So I say no to my wife a lot because she likes to do a lot of stuff. So I said, you know what? I've been saying no to certain stuff, snorkeling and all that. She said, babe, let's kayak because it's free for like a half hour.
Nope.
I've never done it.
Is that? You know what? For you to choose.
I know.
For you to choose that to be the place where you start saying right, yes.
Right.
It's very telling, but go ahead.
And it was the day before we were leaving. So I was like, you know what? Let me, you know, make the lady happy. So we go.
That's the one where you're like.
Yes.
Okay.
Yep. And if you tip over,
you're
just over.
This is you in the water.
Okay.
So,
no big deal.
The guy said, okay, just make sure you stay close because it's the waves. You know, you want to stay as close to the thing as possible, go around these buoys, boom. Again, I've never done it before. Yeah. I seen it on TV though.
Yeah.
And first strike was we got into the kayak and the wife said nothing. She just started paddling. I said, this is already wrong.
This is a team thing.
It's already wrong.
We need to talk to each other.
So,
have you not seen Survivor?
Right. So I'm like paddling. I'm like, hey, babe, so like, are we going that way or which way? No, just, you know, just paddle.
No.
And then she's kind of paddling, but it's weird because she's like scraping the side of the boat as she's paddling. And I'm getting wet because she's like flicking water on me. I'm like, hey, babe, you like getting me. Well, I don't know if you're doing it right. She said, I'm doing it right. This is how I do it. I'm like, oh, boy.
Have you kayaked before?
Yes, allegedly. What trips are you going on, baby? You didn't kayak,
baby.
So I'm like, please, just adjust because you're getting me wet and, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
So we're going and we start going a little further out. And I can feel the waves coming now, right? I can feel the waves coming and I can see the waves. My wife's paddling away. And I hear, stop moving. I said, it's not me. If you look, it's the waves. Because we're this way, and the waves are hitting the side of the kayak. So we're like, okay, we have to turn to be, because we're like a few minutes out now.
Yeah.
We got to turn to be able to redirect our jump. So.
I'm so stressed out right now.
She said, okay, we have to stop first.
No.
She said, just dip the paddle in the water.
No.
I said, wait, what? She said, yeah, just put it in the water, and that should stop us. So we both put it on the same side.
Boy.
Which is probably very wrong. And we put and we took it into the water. On the left side. All the way into the water. I was wearing a life jacket because you never know. And never thank know. God. Because the water at this point where we were was at least up to here. And meaning when the waves came.
It's going over you.
So.
That's
it's
terrifying.
Me, my wife, a kayak, and two oars have to get from where we are back to shore with the kayak. Needless to say, neck, shoulders, tight, and all messed up for the flight.
Oh, so the massages were negated.
Thank you.
Oh man. Yes. Yeah.
Did you cuss her out all the way back to shore?
You can't.
You can.
You can't.
I would have cussed her out.
But you shouldn't. Because you have
a... It's not fair.
I would have.
You have a journey across the globe back with this person.
She's getting cussed out all the way back.
Darren doesn't like peace.
I've been married too long, dude. Every step I would have taken would have been like a... Like, we didn't have to do this. Like...
Get this. We get it back there. Let's do it again. I don't know what's saving me from just saying stuff.
Should have been cussed the fuck out.
I said, no, you got it. No, I wasn't doing
it. No.
Do it on a girl's trip or something.
Yeah, no, sir.
Oh, but besides that, great trip. Great trip. Staff was cool as hell. It was amazing.
Oh,
yeah, I would do it again, for sure. For sure. Yeah, so, and we're back.
Happy had a good time.
We were just like, you know, I was like telling him, I'm like, yeah, Ben went to Maldives, and we're both looking at each other like, where's that at, though? So now we're pulling up our phones. He's asking Siri, I'm Googling. Siri, where's Maldives? And Siri just put the word in some water, but didn't.
Like, yeah, because that's what happened.
He didn't really show much. He's like, there's no land with that. And so then I had to look it up on my Google Maps, and I'm like, oh, there's a whole bunch of little islands.
Mm-hmm.
And we're like, which direction do you go? Like, do you go...
From the main island, it's like further south.
No. I mean, like, from the east coast of America.
Oh, yeah.
Do you fly towards California or do you fly towards Europe?
Europe. Even people from California that we saw there, same. But they just went up north through Canada, but still had to come across the U.S.
You have to take into account which way the earth is spinning.
Yeah, you can't
fly against the current, I guess.
I think the only time that folks fly west is if you're going to Hawaii, but outside of that, and when they go up through Canada and China, probably, I'm not even 100% sure.
If I'm flying from California to China and you make me go all around the world, way around,
but it's right there,
like Magellan, to you.
Yeah, the folks from Cali said they went up through Canada. Then had a layover somewhere.
You gotta really want to go somewhere to just go that far.
Yeah, or you could travel, first class, spend $10,000 and recline and stuff. And they're jerks for having us on Air Qatar, great airline by the way. But you walk past all the beautiful first class things that have the little door and have a desk and all. And then here's your seat next to the crying child. Yeah,
they do that so that next time you're like, you know what. Maybe we should spend the extra few.
I guess my wife said.
That's what she said, right?
And I said, never.
Never.
Never. She said, well, I'd be comfortable if I get... I know. I know.
I don't care. Mm-hmm.
You say never, but... Just like you went kayaking. You're sitting.
Why you got to bring up old stuff? Why you got to bring up old stuff?
Just saying, Bim's going first class somewhere. Mr. Never, you are going.
Only if I could find a deal.
Yeah, deal, Shmuel. You are going. Whether you have deal or not, you are going. I know. Bye. So don't lie to yourself tomorrow. Never.
Because when you're married, you don't have a choice, man.
Just take a shot and just deal with it. Mm.
And it's foul that you know how women are, and you're just like, yeah, you don't have a choice, boy. You're going. Nah.
I mean, you have a choice, but it's not wise. Really.
Well, I'm going to say, you do it, I'm going to say regular.
Yeah, no, you can't do that.
Can't do
it's
that.
It's not wise.
But fire trip, fire wife, fire stay.
Fire life.
Fire life. Oh, lastly, you guys saw Castaway, right?
Mm-hmm.
With Tom Hanks?
Mm-hmm. I've heard of it with the volleyball.
Heard of it. Cool. See, I can't stand her. Wilson! So, Darren, do you remember in Castaway the night scenes?
Yeah.
And how it kind of looked weird?
Somewhat.
Like, it didn't really look like nighttime. And I saw the making of Castaway, and I saw that they filmed a bunch of scenes during the day. For his safety, like, and the crew safety.
Duskish.
Yeah, it didn't. Looking. It looked dark, but in one, it was like fake dark. Yeah. Like I can tell you guys, like tinted the thing or whatever. There was a night where I was up, and it looked just like that. Oh. It looked like fake dark because of how bright the moon was. Like it's.
I was gonna insane. Say I was thinking it was gonna be pitch dark for you, and that would terrify me even more. To wake up and like look out to water and sea,
yeah.
And it's pitch dark.
Yeah, it was I've never seen, and again, you don't have pollution, buildings, all this other stuff. It's just island and pure sky. Mm. So the clouds at night, you know, we can see clouds, but it's not as defined as during the day, where mm-hmm. you can see the mm-hmm. shape and mm-hmm. the color. Mm-hmm. It's still white. The clouds were white at night. It was crazy. It was so crazy. And I was looking at night, and I was like, oh my God, this is Castaway. This is exactly how it looked. The director or whoever did an amazing job of giving you that deserted island look at night because it looked just like they did.
I'm glad I saw that movie.
You should watch it or not.
It's a good movie. She won't I mean, it's a good old movie, but it's a good movie.
Speaking of movies, I did watch a movie and we hadn't talked about it yet.
I was supposed to watch it because you guys said that you was going to
watch
it.
You didn't watch it? The Netflix?
No, streaming services worked out there. Not a single one. Not a single one. Yeah.
Yeah, we watched the, I can't remember what it's called now.
Did you
end up finish it? Oh.
Is it Harder They
Fall? Harder They Come?
Harder They Come?
So you didn't finish it and you didn't watch it. So I guess the one movie I watched, it was actually pretty good.
Can we do it for next time? Mm. Yeah? Yeah? What? Are you going to remember it?
Probably not. But
come on.
You remember it.
But I will say, because I don't watch Westerns, but it was the Western with black people.
Mm.
And so that was different. Even though I guess historically cowboys were black.
Yeah, they definitely were black cowboys.
Regina King looks amazing in that movie.
She's great.
Goddess.
She's amazing.
Goddess.
And also the lady who was in Atlanta.
She's in it too?
Yes.
Oh.
The cast is stacked in that movie.
Yeah. It's a stellar star.
Literally stacked. I was like, damn, is homegirl from Atlanta? And of course, Idris.
Okay.
And
Darius.
And
Darius. Lakeith.
Yeah, thank you. I was telling Lakeith. Darius. And the thing is, when I saw Lakeith, I was like, all right. This movie better not start off great and then end up weird.
Mm.
Yeah, yeah.
Because the last couple of movies.
Sorry for
the interruption.
Yeah.
Starts off great, ends up really weird.
Yeah.
But this one, it just must have been like, no, you're not gonna have a movie with me end weird. It was a good movie. It had a great ending. So if you're looking for something to watch on Netflix, I would suggest it.
Is it based on something historical? Like, is it? Like,
I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. I just watched it. I didn't do any backstory.
Well, Jay-Z has something to do with it also. I think yeah, he's
one of the producers, and you could tell he has something to do with the musical score. So, like, the music choices, I actually was, like, hoping you had watched it.
Like, heard of some fella?
Yes. Yeah. There's definitely some fella in it, and I was like, okay, I could see. This is, like, because you don't think Nigerian music and Western movie would go together, but it actually goes together very well. You know, it fits. And the musical score was done very well in that movie.
And Deion Cole had something to do with the movie, too, I think. Oh, he was in it.
Stacked.
Yeah. I got to watch this.
Stacked cast.
Wow. Okay.
And he wasn't even like a star of the movie.
Mm.
Just think about that.
Mm. Darren, for next week.
Yeah.
We could do it?
I'm in it.
Okay. I'm watching without the wife.
Oh.
Because, you know.
How would you watch without the wife?
You said, why not?
Why would you watch without the wife?
We have a queue of so many shows. Like, Dexter's back. Have you watched?
Dexter's back. No, I almost feel like I'm going to refuse to watch it.
Because?
Because I hated the way it ended.
Watch it.
Okay. Oh, yeah? Okay. I mean, it takes none but a sentence from him.
Yeah.
Jen is so disgusted.
We were upset that this week they didn't have an episode because of Thanksgiving.
Oh.
Yeah, so three episodes deep so far.
Oh, okay.
But Dexter, Insecure. Mm-hmm. We still haven't watched Chang Shi or whatever. And a few other movies. The Marvel movie.
Oh, okay. Shang-Chi? Yeah, okay.
Have you seen it?
No.
I heard it's one
of them. I haven't seen anything Marvel.
Really?
Yeah, Eternals.
Oh, that did come out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm interested.
I even downloaded something to watch, and I haven't watched it yet.
Hmm.
I think Hawkeye is out.
Not yet.
I think, or coming. Oh,
Thursday or Friday this week.
Yeah.
I've been watching the new season of Curb.
You know what I did?
I need to watch that.
Because I've only seen, I think I saw whatever the season is before the last in its entirety. I went back to season one. I want to watch everything.
I wanted to do that, but I know I'm not going to do that.
Mm.
The only season I remember even watching at all was the one, which was season 6 with J.B. Smoove and Vivica Fox.
That sounds funny.
And J.B.'s still in it.
Yes.
which is crazy to me. I'm like, how? You weren't even supposed to be in it to begin with.
When you funny, man, you gonna hang. They're going to find a way to write you in.
I know, but like, in that season with him and Vivica, like, the family came, and he was just like, he wasn't even really part of the family. Like, it's great. I love JB.
When he has his, you see his commercials when he sees her, or whatever, the betting. Yeah. I laugh. Just by looking at him,
he's
laugh.
He's so funny.
I saw him at the, what hotel was it? Mirage in Vegas.
Really?
Walking in the lobby, I said, hey, yo, JB. He turned around and goes, oh, you're just a man. You're just a man. Oh.
Gotta love JB.
I love it.
We just watched the new edition, New Kids on the Block battle that they had on the AMAs the other day.
I'm sorry, what?
I just watched it. Yeah, the American Music Awards came on a couple days ago.
Huh.
And Cardi B was hosting. And it came out of nowhere because I'm like, first of all, they still do award shows.
And AMAs.
AMAs. That's the one where, like, Michael Jackson used to always win. Mm. You know, I used to like the AMAs. That was the one I was kind of like, oh, this is kind of cool. It's, like, a little better than the Grammys, but whatever. So, yeah, they started promoting it, like, the week of. Mm. Just out of nowhere. So Cardi B was hosting and this and that. And then Tisha had actually sent to us that they were having a New Kids on the Block, New Edition performance, and I was like, what, like a battle of Boston? And she was like, that's actually what they're calling it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Are they stealing like Versus vibe or something with that?
I don't know. So right before I came here, actually, I put it on because I hadn't watched it. My homegirl at work was like, did you watch it? And I'm like, no, not yet. I've been meaning to watch it, blah, blah, blah. And so as they're performing, because they did it kind of like New Kids would do a song, mm-hmm. then they switched to new Edition, they do a song, and then back and forth. Mm. And they kept panning to the crowd, and it's JB and, like, his wife. I'm like, why didn't you show JB's move? I mean, I'm cool with it.
My God.
I mean, they're just jamming.
But is it worth watching the performance?
Yeah, it's like 10 minutes. I would
and it was good?
It. Yeah, it was entertaining.
Hmm. You didn't say good, too. What Bobby did.
Bobby was singing. It was just funny, because it's like, you know, my first question when I heard that was happening was, is it going to be Bobby and Johnny?
Mm.
And it was both. Mm. But you know, Johnny's like an actual singer, and the rest of them.
Don't do that.
I'm going to do it. I did it. Ralph could sing. Ralph could sing, yeah. But you never knew that.
We knew that.
We didn't know that till like.
He was the lead in the beginning.
We didn't know that till the movie came out. You might have known that.
Yeah, we was on the VHS tape. We were recording all their videos.
I didn't know Ralph was the lead singer till the movie came
too
out.
Too busy listening to Barris. Look at that.
You shut the hell up. The movie came out, and I was like, yo, he did sing all them parts.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Sensitivity was my jam.
Come on now.
My absolute jam. But that was after New Edition.
His solo joint, yeah.
Yeah, had fizzed out and everything, where they was trying to give him his solo. He was supposed to have a solo career.
Yeah, it didn't pan out as well.
Because he sacrificed that to be part of the group.
Right.
Good for him, I guess. But yeah, so Johnny's like on one end, and Bobby's on the other end. Ralph's kind of like in the middle. And then them other Belva DeVoe.
Don't do that. You almost send them other dudes.
BBD's like sprinkled in between.
Ain't right.
But it was fun.
But I'm thinking of the songs that New Kids on the Block have.
Oh. It was fun.
I ain't gonna hold you. I had a New Kids on the Block tape.
It was fun.
I had their bed sheets.
Okay.
What'd you had just say?
I had their bed sheets. Ask me why? I don't know.
Right stuff.
Darren, hold on.
I didn't buy them. My mother did.
Clearly.
So they ain't let you listen to like hip hop, but they're going to get you these NKOTB sheets.
Like, they had like pink squares and everything.
You know how every week we're like, you can't write this stuff and you're not ever ready for it?
It's the flashback episode of old Darren where they keep going back to his youth and he gets in bed and gets tucked
into the
in.
Joey. The Joey.
I don't know why. I don't know, but Adam, I remember him.
Jesus Christ. All right, stuff.
Damn. Sheets, bro?
What am I going to tell you, Bim? What am I going to tell you?
That's wild.
You're never ready for how amazing this is going to be.
Oh, my God. Oof. A lot of stuff happened when I was gone. Like
a slew of things.
You guys would mention something in the chat. I'm like, wait, huh? One of them being the Versus battle with Chaka Khan and
I just
Stephanie
started
Mills.
Watching a little bit of that right before I came here, too.
Oh, I thought you saw it the night it happened.
No, I forgot
all about that.
I was like, let me just put on, because I kept seeing like people talk about how Chaka was so drunk, and I'm like,
oh, no.
She sounds like she was the Q Sweat.
No.
And looking at it, yeah, she was bad.
Oh.
Yeah. apparently some dude came out. I like stepped away from the TV for a minute, and he was like, "Yo, somebody came to change her shoes." So she had heels on, and she sat down, and some dude apparently came and took her heels off and put on some like combat boots. So
oh
she
could... boy!
Yeah, you don't give 68-year-old Ciroc. I mean,
why were they drinking it?
I mean, they probably drank it before they got on stage. I mean, it's sponsored by Ciroc.
But we saw Patty and we saw Gladys.
They probably don't drink.
They were chilling. It was very, adult.
Was Ciroc a big part of it at that point?
I don't think so. And even if it was, they didn't even bother bringing that stuff out.
Yeah.
But even, like, just the way they carried themselves, though, was, you know, damn, they were trying to get, like, hype. Like, what? Shaka was drunk.
So it's like, so you saw the Bobby and Keith one, how Bobby had to keep singing the Keith Sweat songs.
Yeah.
That's what Stephanie Mills was doing.
What?
Singing all the Shaka songs.
That's not a good look. Oh, boy. Ouch. Oh, no.
But I realized that Shaka Khan could play like Nicki Minaj's mom in a movie or something.
Absolutely. Crazy. In like the nose area.
And then they had the big hair, the big red hair. I was like, oh, my gosh, she looks like old Nicki Minaj.
Yeah, she could pull that. What else did I miss? I saw Young Dolph.
Murdered.
So rest in peace, Young Dolph.
Just after we recorded, the Rittenhouse verdict came out.
Oh.
That's terrible.
Saw it at the airport.
He did a... I just saw it real quick on the news this morning. He did a interview on Fox News.
Ugh.
And he was saying, like, how he supports Black Lives Matter and blah, 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 blah. I was like, you know, let me just...
Go away.
Get dressed and go to work.
For those who don't know what we're talking about, Kyle Rittenhouse was acquitted on all charges.
Now, what I will say is, one, I didn't follow the trial. Two, I don't know anything about the people who were killed. And how do I say this? The men who lost their lives were also white. And this was a protest of Jacob Blake, right?
Mm-hmm.
Getting shot in the back by police, who was a black man in Wisconsin. And so, you know, there's probably people of all races there. And so the odds of an altercation happening with this young white man who has a assault rifle and two other white men, I can kind of almost see it happening because I'm like, if I saw a white kid with a big gun, I'm not going towards him, right? So for you to be like, oh, I'm going towards him, you have to also be part of that vigilante justice.
Yeah,
like,
You can't do that.
Right.
Right.
You can't carry that here. You can't bring that here. I'm coming to
stop you.
I'm coming to stop you.
Yeah.
And same as if that's what Rittenhouse was doing when he came there, I'm coming here with my gun to stop you.
Yeah.
So now it's a battle of vigilantes. Where it ended poorly.
Yeah. It was like, what am I watching?
And so, and I didn't watch the videos of anything of what happened, but I'm like, it sounds like both sides were instigating, if I had to just use my gut. Yeah. But once again, I didn't follow the trial.
Yeah.
That's what it feels like.
Neither one needed to cross each other's path.
Yeah, right.
The Kyle didn't need to cross state lines with a rifle for any reason.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody needed to approach him.
Right. Because as soon as somebody approaches him, it can easily be
self-defense.
That's exactly what happened.
That's all, yeah. So.
You know, because they're like, oh, one of the guys hit him with a skateboard. Right.
Yep. They like kind of knocked him down. He scuffled, got up, was able to get.
Yeah. You're always going to get the self-defense in that case. Yep. Well, unless you're black, but in most cases.
Yeah, no, I would see the, that way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Other way.
Well, we were talking about that. The nonsense radar.
Oof. Hi.
Everybody running. I'm running too. Hey, we out of here. We saw it at the airport when we were leaving Qatar. And we were sitting on the plane about to board, and that popped up on the news.
Mm-hmm.
Just tapped the wife. Like, we going back to that country?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Ah.
Right. Mm-hmm. Other things that happened. Jacob Chansley, one of the people that stormed the Capitol.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, he got sentenced.
He got sentenced to 3 years in prison.
Okay.
I think he already served maybe 6 months.
I think it was like close to a year. Like, I think whatever's left is like 2.5 years.
Yeah.
He's the one that had the Viking hat on.
Yeah.
Oh, he's like the key one that they've been
So if the main guy gets 3.5 years for treason. Like,
Do you think that's long enough?
No.
Well, so I don't know the law enough to know for sure, but that if he's the guy that I kept seeing
over and over,
that seems like he's going to be the one to get the longest sentence.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a police officer did lose his life that day, right?
Mm-hmm.
Anything about anybody who had to do any had something to do with that?
Not that I've seen, but I haven't really looked. I just kind of came across that headline.
I mean, I would think any parties involved in that would be the focal point, you know, and they would be made the biggest example of. But for that guy to be the, because it's only because we saw him with the Viking helmet. If we didn't see that or him doing that stuff, we wouldn't even know who he was. Very interesting.
But what I have been noticing, which is something that we've been kind of following, is that it feels like whatever the case is that the government's trying to make against Trump, they're building it slowly. You know, so they're starting with, like, the bottom pieces, the foundation. Okay, then we're going to... So now they've got this whole Steve Bannon thing. He's one, right? They subpoenaed him and then he didn't go.
Oh,
you missed all that?
Yeah, I have no idea what's going on in America.
Yeah, so, like, they... Well, this is before you even left.
Oh,
I'm they, like, subpoenaed... I think Steve Bannon, he's like the main one, like the funny looking one. And he was like, nah, I'm just not going. Like Congress subpoenaed him and he's like, I'm not going.
You can do that?
Exactly. They're like, you can't do that.
There's different rules.
You can't. No. So then I think now he's been arrested.
He's been arrested?
But he got to turn himself in because you know how that goes. But yeah, so it's like they're building it and now they're like, you know, subpoenaing some more people. And I feel like this is just a guess because once again, I don't know anything. Because, you know, Trump's going to try to run again in 2024.
Is that still a thing?
That's a thing.
Oh, yeah.
And so I feel like they're trying to build the case in such a way that it's so strong by the time it comes for people to start running, he won't be able to do it.
Okay.
That's what I feel like. That's what my hope. But yeah, I don't know.
And it's wild. Look what we got to do to keep him
not It's so crazy running. Because if he runs, like, right now, he's going to win.
He's winning. It's... I haven't even heard from Biden. He all right?
Biden's got a he's had a tough 6 months.
I know he just had a
Okay.
He just had a colonoscopy done, and in that for an hour we had our first female black president. So because he was placed in anesthesia for this procedure, he had to hand he had to hand over power. So for an hour,
people were all on the internet.
Yeah.
We got our first woman president.
I'm sick of everybody.
Stop it.
I thought it was interesting.
Stop it.
I'm so sick of everybody.
Small victories.
And she ain't said nothing neither.
No.
I don't care.
I know they both
said nothing.
She ain't got. She's MIA like a moke.
So look what happens, right? We had now. I'm not of the same thought of some people, but. Two terms with Obama, and some people were not satisfied. I'm talking like black and brown people, right?
Mm-hmm.
We got Trump, and now we have, I always say it wrong, Kamala. Kamala and Biden, right? First black woman VP, first female VP. Obama's vice president. We lit. We here, guys. We did it. Hey, where you guys at, man? We done, huh? I can't get in the club? Wait, what? But I voted. You didn't, man, this gas, what's going on? I don't know anything.
Yeah.
So what's going to happen the next time somebody runs up against a Democrat? It's going to go to the other side again because
nothing.
And I'm okay with a Republican being president. We've had Republican presidents. I just don't want somebody who's like Trump, who runs based off of using people's hate for other people to get ahead. I don't need that kind of Republican. But if you're just a Republican who's like, yeah, I'm going in and I just want people who got money to keep money, whatever.
I don't care about that. Right. I'm with you. But the problem now, because the stage has been set, right?
Yeah.
Trump did what he did and people saw the success of it. And we got these folks now. It's going to be so easy to run against them and slander them for what they didn't do.
Yep.
And it just becomes, because that's election season, right? They suck. No, you suck. It's just
like
anger.
We literally just watched the movie The Campaign again like a month ago.
Man.
Not even.
Man.
And who was that with?
Will Ferrell and dude from Hangover.
Alan, the fat guy.
Oh, okay, okay. Okay, okay. Yeah. Got it.
And, I mean, I watched it when it came out, and it was kind of like, ha, 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 ha.
Zach Galifianakis.
No, that's not.
The fat guy?
No, it's not Zach Galifianakis. Is it?
Are you sure? I
don't know. Yeah, Zach Galifianakis.
Maybe.
Galifianakis.
But watching it again, and that movie came out way before Trump ran, so it's even scarier. And it's funny because in that movie, the candidate who acts more Trump-like was the Democrat.
Mm-hmm.
No.
And
they flipped it, yeah.
And the candidate, because honestly, the titles are really just for show.
It's just a title.
It's just a title.
Guess what? They're all rich.
They're all rich. They're all old. They're all white. Yeah. And they all come from long lines of political families and military families. And
they all hang out, too. They'll beef on TV, on CNET or whatever, and then go get drinks together. Meanwhile, people are suffering. People are arguing in real life, hating each other, and y'all are just playing the game. It's like people beefing over sports. It's the same thing. Might as well be like Man United against whatever soccer people watch, and those people like fighting for real. It's the same.
It's kind of like when we watched Universal with Dipset and the Lox, and they had to like tell people like, "No, we're actually cool."
Because they're goons.
The crowd was getting rowdy.
Oh man, America's different, man. America's different. Still home though, I guess.
I guess.
That's the problem with going away, like being away.
Yeah.
You kind of realize. I sound like Will Smith. You kind of realize how
you did kind of sound. Like,
yeah.
You kind of realize.
So, what happens?
All the hands too.
Right. When you really look now, you realize how much a lot of this doesn't mean anything, and we don't like. Wife was annoyed with me probably because I just kept going on about how money is fake and we don't need it.
Yo, so, wait. That's been the speech of the month.
The same way you were like, yo, can you just give me peace? You know, she probably was like, and he just kept talking about money and it's just like, it's, okay, all right, man.
See,
all right.
I'm trying to like get her third eye to dilate. You feel me?
And she's trying to open up your heart.
No. No, she was just talking about something that didn't matter. It mattered, but it didn't matter.
That's what she's thinking about your little money talk.
Nah, it's real. Because when you can see...
Sound like Kanye for a second. I mean, he did. Nah, it's real.
Yo, oh, another thing about the Kanye interview. I'm sorry. Do you guys remember they said he doesn't have a home?
Yeah, that's crazy.
Because it's usually the rich people. And he said it. The rich people will go and backpack with nothing. Because you realize obtaining all that stuff, it doesn't even matter. What mattered is relationships. So he can go to Florida and stay with Nori. He can go to Italy and stay with the Gucci guy or the whatever. He can go to Texas and stay with Elon Musk because relationships are what matters. He's saying something and people don't get it. It's real.
People are spending so much money on these mansions for what?
I'm sorry.
Ben was like, ah. I'm just like,
because yeah, she gets it.
I'm with you.
Spending
all this money on mansions for what?
Right. And unfortunately, I mean, fortunately, it's like a double-edged sword and gift and a curse because America, people will kill to get here. And I feel bad complaining about it because I do understand we're in a much better position than a lot of people. But also being within the system and seeing how pardon my cuss, how bullshit it can be at times and for no reason. Bipartisan government, which literally pits people against each other that live with each other. And it just creates a hostile environment. And it's on purpose. And it doesn't matter. Ah, man. I'm sorry. I got to go back to the beach. I'm sorry.
That's fine. Speaking of, I just want to say thank you to everyone who donated and helped out with our Thanksgiving drive.
Yes.
Even though we tried to not do it last minute this time and we planned it ahead of time, life got involved and we... You know, had a little bit of hiccups with execution, but you guys really showed up and showed out. We made an extra basket even. Yep.
Amazing.
It was awesome. And the people who received them were very, very thankful. So we thank you again for all your help. And it really opens your eyes to how much need there is out there.
Yeah, indeed.
Because, you know, we put these baskets together and we're just like, okay, you know, the turkey and some canned goods, some non-perishables, some mashed potatoes. Yep. And, you know, it's like, okay, this is cool. And, like, for me, I feel like, I'm like, oh, is this even going to be received well?
Yeah.
Is somebody going to be like, what am I supposed to do with this?
Yeah.
And then you see the message from the people, like, thank you or whatever. And it's like, oh, or yeah, we need that food because we have more people than food.
Mm. Yeah.
And it's like, oh, okay. This is really, this is what it is out here. And we've talked about before, like, how people are like, oh, there's stimulus money and there's unemployment and these people are getting all this money. It's, but people have bills that they got to pay with this money. People aren't just getting free money, right, air quotes, to just blow. And yeah, there's some people who took advantage and got PPP loans when they shouldn't have and this and that.
You going to jail.
And right. That's a whole other situation, right?
You going to jail, people.
Because those people now wanna complain like the government set them up.
Fam. Darren, can you imagine?
Have you seen that? We'll go there after. But there's actual real people who really needed these resources and really need this help. Right. And who are trying to make it day to day, got kids, got their parents are taking care of their whatever. And so to be able to just be able to impact even one person like that really touches us from the bottom of our hearts. So we just want to say thank you to everybody who helped.
Seriously, huge thanks.
And God bless everybody. Have a great Thanksgiving. Yeah. I mean, you're going to hear this after Thanksgiving.
But... Oh, happy Thanksgiving. Hope everybody's Thanksgiving went well.
Turkey.
Yeah. And may the creator replenish your pockets, because we don't take that for granted either, that you came out your pocket for this. We know you did it for good, and we know you probably understand that other people have less than you, but it still takes a lot to dig in your pocket to give your $10, $20, $30, $100,
even
whatever
your time just to go to the store and put that stuff together and come meet with us to, and you know what I mean? Just everything it entailed. So we're really appreciative of everything you guys did.
Right. Mm-hmm. And I think I speak for me because I'm the Grinch the holiday season. That, what you guys did, because I wasn't here to participate, I'm sorry, but what you guys did, that's what matters for the holiday season. Mm-hmm. That's to me at least, is what this is about. You know what I'm saying? Yep. Same thing for Christmas. I hate consumerism because there are people who don't have that will overspend or take themselves. Out credit, kill themselves for these things that don't matter, right? That their kids will throw off in the corner after playing with it twice. Mm-hmm. When there are people who
really do have nothing.
You know, that excess, why not pour into somebody else? Mm-hmm. Pour into somebody that'll really change their holiday. So I give you guys immense props for your time that you spent running around putting stuff together. Honestly. I saw the chat and the back and forth and what y'all had to do, and it's not easy, you know, because you guys got things you're doing too, so... God bless you.
Just
man.
Labor of love. Especially, like you were saying, it kind of opened up my eyes to, like, just how fortunate... Like, I am to not be in a position where I'm like, damn, like, what am I going to make? How am I going to get this food? So definitely any chance to give back is it's a good effort.
And shout out, of course, to your wife, you know.
Oh, yeah. My honey bunny. She she helped us put a lot of things together and get the food into people's hands, which was super appreciative.
Village.
Yes. It takes a village.
Village. And that phrase, and I know you guys are the village, but it's so true, man.
Yeah.
We don't even have, like, actual villages. But if we had actual villages, nobody would be hungry.
Right.
You feel me? Like, if Darren, if Warwick was your village, right?
Warwick village.
It is his village.
Kamimikin village.
If Kamimikin was, like, an actual village, right? And your neighbor, you seen them, they was looking kind of lean.
And they was like, yo, you want some KFC?
Fam, here. Have some of this biscuit. You know what I'm saying? If it was an actual village. So, man, good job, guys.
Darren hates us.
There's a reason I don't like you guys.
Whatever, it's fine.
Shout out to Darlin, because he's the one who kind of puts the battery in my back to get this going. He's a great guy.
Yep. Shout out to Darlin there. And... I don't know. Like, it makes me happy because like it's like like that one message I shared with you guys. One of the people that was like, I didn't know what I was gonna do.
Yeah, so, that one hit me.
Yeah,
that one hit me. Yeah. That's when I was like, yo, this is real out here.
Yeah,
yeah.
I said to the wife, I'm blessed that we don't find ourselves in that position.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've had a few conversations this week about it. Like damn. You don't really, I mean, you know, we grumble about, oh, I gotta go to work. Yeah. But to have the opportunity to have a job where you make the kind of money you make to be able to live the kind of life you live is not something that we should take for granted. You know what I mean? Yeah. And because there's a lot of people who, even if they tried their hardest and had their best day, could not do what we're doing. So
that's a fact.
You know, it's
and not even just like the resource aspect. I think like the support aspect to have family or friends to really fall back on. Like I know if I'm in a tough spot, I can lean on one of you guys to help and help me up. And
like even you were saying, like with the kids not being in school for 10 days or whatever, and how you had to rely on
Scarlet.
At the end of the day, the kids were alive. and they were happy. That's all that matters.
Oh my God. You see my life. She's telling the story and I'm like, it's done. No, it's got no, more. More. It's just...
I definitely was like, is this what I sound like? Is this what I put them through? Is this what I do to them? As a matter of fact, the next day she texts me, she goes, oh, me and Chris want to take you and Clara to dinner.
Aww.
Guess where?
Have you been there before?
I have never been there.
Turn up. Turn up, man.
Yo, I forgot about the Twinos part. That, let me tell you something, Jack. I haven't said let me tell you something, Jack, in a long time. Let
it's true. It's true.
Because that whole, like, 10 minutes before I asked her, I was sitting there thinking it. I'm like, yo, oh my God. Did she get
I've never been so happy that you asked that question. Because when I heard, I was like, how did we even get there? Yeah. How did we even get to where she...
I'm like, I want to ask what she fed the kids. I'm like, nah.
Nah.
She fed them regular
why,
kids
why
stuff.
Why would I ask a stupid question?
Why would I ask them questions? Yeah. She took them to McDonald's or something.
Fam said Twino. I said, ha? Ha?
Oh,
she took a child to a prom venue.
She took a 9-year-old to a prom venue. That is absolutely
in the middle of the day on a weekday.
Scarlett, come hang out, please. Please.
Amazing. She's like, what? Why? And then I took a nap.
The nap.
There was so many layers. I really said, is this what I put them through when I'm telling a story?
The nap. Oh, my God.
Oh, boy.
But can we talk about the people with the PPP loans?
Oh, go ahead, please.
I mean, I'm just saying, I seen a video of some lady and she's just like, oh, it's like a whole thing on Instagram how the government gave people PPP loans or whatever, and then people took the loans, but then they put the whole list on the internet of who got the loans, and so therefore the government set people up because now they're putting people in jail, and so if you put people in jail, then you're going to put their kids in the system, and you put the citizens in the system, and then now when they get out of jail, they're on probation, so they can't get a job.
This woman is saying all this?
Yeah. So the government basically is setting up black people, and I'm like, nah, fam, chill.
Thank you. Thank you.
You got to have some accountability.
And that's the problem.
That's the word.
That's the word.
That's the word.
Is this like a Hotep person?
Nah, I don't know. Okay. Just some lady.
Just a lady.
Maybe some sit on the Explore page.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Wow.
So I've kind of dove into the Hotep life.
Did you? How'd that feel?
Oh, it was terrible. But it was so good.
Brother, how you feel, King?
Was this on TikTok, Darren?
It was.
You found Hotep TikTok?
I started drinking.
Give me your phone.
I don't know. Give me your phone. I started drinking.
Your phone.
No, alkaline water.
Sea moss.
Hotep Talk.
Grand Rising, Kings and Queens. I definitely was deep. I was definitely deep. I was deep in a hole.
You know this fool said Hotep Talk. Yo, I'm going back to my beach, man.
Nah, keep it. I like it. Hotep Talk.
Hotep Talk.
This week.
Hashtag Hotep Talk.
Women, don't forget to submit to a man. Doesn't matter which one. Just
so you want trouble. In the holiday
that's
season.
That's what the talk is.
Don't talk. You don't talk it. You don't have to talk it.
It's fun. It's so funny, babe.
Put the talk if you back li- in the
if
tick.
You,
talk.
If you listen to the things they like actually like really believe, it's like, who, man? Oh, dear.
Now, if those shenanigans land them someone that actually have those same beliefs,
good for them.
God bless.
God bless.
Mm. God bless. But don't bring that noise to Happy Homes.
No, Grand Rising over here.
Grand Rising. Call. Grand Rise Biscuits.
Grand opening, grand closing.
Goddamn, Jen.
Hotep Talk.
Hotep Talk.
Hotep Talk. Whatever. Keep that
so, yeah, if you took a PPP business loan knowing you ain't had no business with no business. I'm going to put it out there, fellas. I got to say it. If you took a business loan and you ain't had no business, and then you got the check, and you went and bought some Gucci or some bullshit, and now they're coming for you,
right.
Don't say the government set you up.
Right.
You knew you didn't have no real LLC when you set up.
Ooh, Jen, don't say anything.
Oh.
Don't say the name.
Oh. I can't think of the name.
Oh, do we know somebody specifically?
I do.
Ooh, girl.
We'll messy. Talk.
I know it. We talked about this. A name that has like LLC in the name.
And it wasn't an LLC.
And it wasn't an LLC. Oh, but continue.
Right.
Yeah. If you set up Weaves and Things LLC and you knew.
There was no Weaves or Things?
No Weaves, no Things.
That's a good name, though.
Weaves and Things LLC.
I like that. I got to look it up.
I mean, I just made that up. So if that's like a real thing, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
You know, just... Don't blame nobody but yourself. They told everybody when they put that out there that if you take this and it's not real, we coming for you when this virus is under control.
They said it.
They said it several times. They said, don't play. We coming for you.
If there's one thing the government does not play with.
It's that money.
That
it's
money. That money. Fake money.
That fake money that's ain't real.
They gonna get it back. To do what with? I don't know.
Because the Staples Center is now the Bitcoin.com.
The cryptos. Crypto.com center. The you cripping on the West Coast now. In the center. I'm glad I went when it was Staples Center. I don't know what this crypto thing is.
Crypto.com. They're going to rehabilitate or whatever the stadium with money that ain't real.
Right. Other fake money.
Other fake money. They're going to rebuild the stadium. Who going to pay for this? Real money. Put it in your bra, bitch. It was a $2 bill?
It's a $2 bill.
Damn, you got a $2 bill?
If I didn't have one at home already, I would have kept it.
Just floating in your random sweatpant pocket?
Is it like a lucky $2 bill?
No, my father gave it to one of the boys. And they didn't have pockets, and they gave it to me.
Ladies and gentlemen, go in there, a $2 bill just fell out of Darren's pocket nonchalantly. Like,
but you never seen the money before?
Here in downtown Warwick, he spent, spent twos.
At the bank, you can get you know, a stack of $2 bills.
You broke, you spend ones in Providence. We spend twos out here.
So what are we looking for threesomes at the liquor store? Oh my
God. Should I tell people about that?
If you want to. But before you do, I'm going to...
Go ahead.
Yeah. The wife came across this article we shared. Headline. 480-pound woman is charged.
Okay, let me put that down.
Yes. With involuntary manslaughter after the husband died while performing oral sex.
Okay.
So me and the wife have this joke about sitting on my face, blah, 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 blah. Wow. It's not a joke, but it's a joke. And guess this woman, husband said, hey, back it on up like you, haul truck.
Come on now.
Sit on my face. And apparently... After 25 minutes.
That's a long time.
What?
After 25 minutes, man's wasn't moving no more.
Oh, how many pounds was she?
480.
Keep up.
Wait a minute. No. Wait a minute, though.
An Ohio woman has been sentenced to involuntary manslaughter after her spouse was found dead minutes after he had performed oral sex. But it says minutes, and then like later on in the article, it says she was there for about 20 minutes.
Fam,
right.
Wait a minute. First of all, she's selfish. Okay.
First of all.
How you?
First of all.
What? Oh, was it that good?
Yeah, cardiac arrest while apparently being suffocated to death.
Oh my God. Did she finish?
So the question, so.
Can you imagine she ain't even get off?
Of course, now we go into this huge spiral of a conversation over this. Did he suffocate to death or did he drown?
Valid question. But I think he suffocated because they would have said fluids caused for him to... Yes, so I think he suffocated. But that's a good question.
So we're amongst... We went over to Mushi's house. Shout out to Mushi on Saturday. So we're all together and we're all like... So now the guys are like, there's a plethora of things that I'm going to do before I die under there.
Yes. You gotta punch her right in the food bowl. What are you talking about?
Punch! I'm biting.
I'm gonna catch a case before you kill me. I'm catching a case before you kill me.
Feet wiggling, like.
And that's why I call this selfish, because I'm sure he tried something.
And she just ignored all the signs.
Because you can't drown yourself, right? If I do this.
So it depends.
You can't drown
yourself. If he. Laid down like this.
Show me.
Like arms down, and then so now his arms are trapped under her legs.
480 pounds.
But if he's not a big man, he didn't look like he was
He's also not a wise man if you trap your arms.
Exactly.
With this lady.
Exactly that. Because I make sure up here, just in case
Know your exits. Safety first is my thing.
That's what they teach you in wrestling. One, two,
Get the shoulder off the mat.
Right, exactly.
Oh
that.
My God. Know your exits.
Or
sir.
You do the kick.
Oh my God. That is terrible.
It's terrible. Now, the worst thing to me is she's actually being charged.
Why is that worse?
Somebody got to pay. He died.
I'm sure
imagine
she
that was like your peoples. You want her to just be walking free and worried?
It clearly wasn't.
Where her little happy vagina?
Right, to claim another victim?
It's not little. And, ooh, wow. And, I
Somebody got to pay. And it's involuntary, right?
She lost her husband. I'm sure it wasn't.
She killed that man. Mm. She killed that man, Darren.
Do you think this was like a first-time ordeal?
I think they had some close calls before. And they probably established a safe word, but he couldn't say nothing. Man, you know.
I'm punching something.
Oh, man. Did they give ages? How old they were?
Yeah, 28 and 31.
What? Oh, they were young. Oh.
Wait, let me make sure. Let me look back at the article.
What?
Oh, no. That's even worse. Oh, my God.
Annabelle. Oh, I'm not going to put. Sorry. She's 28. He's 31.
Oh, my Lord. 31?
31?
31?
Come on.
They gotta put
The quote is so much worse. We were having sex, and he started eating my beep, and I was just sitting on his face for like 25 minutes
when his
legs turned a greenish-blue color.
Okay. All right. Bim's had enough. So this man wasn't even really licking nothing. She was just enjoying the feeling of her own flesh touching itself.
Right.
And...
Her lawyer is trying to appeal the 10-year and 6-month sentence.
Whoa.
Given to her for reckless conduct.
Bim is stressed.
Yeah, nah.
He said appeal.
So he was gone for a while.
He was gone.
He was gone for a while.
His legs were changing color.
Flatline.
So this is gone.
When have you ever been involved in any sexual act, and if the other party was motionless?
Yeah.
For more than 10 seconds,
dude,
you don't check it. Hey, you still awake?
Babe.
20 minutes? Enough time for his legs to change color? Under the jail. I don't care. I don't even feel bad. Under the jail. Are you kidding me? Appeal. Lawyer, you're a devil. Under the jail. You sat on the... Anyways.
480 is not small. I mean, a ton is what, 2,000 pounds? So it's like a quarter ton?
Come on. You know you're heavy.
That's like the trunk of a car.
You know you're heavy. Lady. Lady. And this guy. God rest his soul. He was with you. He tried, though. He tried.
You ever watch 600 Pound Life?
No, I won't dare.
I can't stand the show. My friends watch it. Every now and then I catch myself. And these 600 pound people always have a husband or a wife who's willing to wipe them. And feed them.
Oh, that's love.
Wipe them and feed them.
That's love.
I'm distraught right now.
That is love.
And you want to complain about talking on the beach.
Baby, I'm so sorry. Talk as much as you like. Damn. You know why it's sad, guys? We've all had sex. And it's supposed to be fun, right? Imagine you're doing this with somebody you love.
And they die.
And they don't even care about you enough to make sure you're okay during the process.
Oh, I was thinking about the other side of it.
What are you thinking about?
The fact that the guy died. You're like, oh, this is so good, baby. Oh.
But he was dead for a little bit.
Yeah, that's sad.
So what was she enjoying when she was sitting there?
That's what I was saying. She was just feeling her own flesh touching itself because she got a lot of extra meat.
Yeah, but you got to know when somebody's gone limp.
Come on. She's probably doing all this.
The legs have to.
She's the one doing all of this, and she's.
You wanted to come here.
I'm not lying. I'm very sad. This is a sad story.
It's a terrible story. Darren is dark.
God.
Darren is dark.
Darren.
I did smile.
His legs were changing. They changed color,
A greenish blue.
And that's the only reason why she stopped. Because she noticed that his legs were a different color.
She said, uh-oh.
Get her out of here, man.
I'm not even going to lie. I've never looked at the person's legs.
Because they were still interacting with you.
They were alive.
And also... I feel like, okay, there's things that you have to worry about and you don't have to worry about. Jen, I'm
not 480.
But I'm sure you could be flung off and very easily. You know what I mean? Like,
he's flung me for less.
One arm.
She hits the wall and like slides all the way down.
I can't breathe, stupid.
I've totally gotten flung for less.
I mean, that's what I mean. I can get my wife off me if I need to move.
Fam, and we've done it.
I'm sure. Move.
Almost killed me today. What's wrong with you?
All bad looking at her.
What's wrong with you? My nose. Sorry.
I'm all wet. looking at her in disgust. She's like, I'm sorry, babe. I'm sorry. I know you're sorry.
Play too much.
You don't listen. I told you. You didn't see my hands and my feet kicking.
Jen, it's very scary. It can be very scary. And this man died.
He said, I'm all wet.
Oh, dear.
Yikes.
I'm stressed. This is stupid.
Sorry. Sorry.
Oh,
guys.
Man. Darren. Why must you? Damn. That is so sad.
It is.
He got GoFundMe.
I don't know. Huh. What? GoFundMe for what?
I don't know. His family. They got kids. That's so sad. Mm. She has to go to jail. Damn. Ah. Take us higher, man.
Take us higher.
Shoot. That is so crazy.
How do we take ourselves higher from there?
I don't know. Thanksgiving plans.
Thanksgiving. What you doing?
It came and gone already. But what I did for Thanksgiving, we had some grub at the crib.
Yay.
My son's here.
Hey.
Facial, he just let it grow in.
Oh, all, yeah.
All passion. I'm like, damn, dogs. It's kind of weird. Every time we go somewhere and there's people that I know who haven't seen Dylan before, like, oh, he's just a light-skinned Bim.
Yeah.
Oh, is that yeah. Right?
I brought the yearbooks last week.
Oh, yeah.
This one in my car. And I looked at your picture, and I was like, oh, shoot, Dylan.
The older he gets, I'm like, oh, damn. It really is. It's crazy. Crazy, crazy.
It's nuts.
Man. But, yeah, aww. So I'm at the crib, and then went to her aunt's crib, and we got some grub there, and ended up at Miscellaneous Place to round the night up. What do you guys got planned?
We are going to in-law's house to hang out and do nothing.
Did you see the picture?
That's about it. We don't have much planned.
Just the in-laws?
Mm-hmm.
Y'all cooking and bringing stuff over there? Or?
Mm-hmm.
What you cooking? What
you fixing?
I'm not cooking a damn thing.
I know that's
oh,
right.
Damn. All right, King. You, the Hotep.
Yeah.
The woman
cooks. Belongs in the kitchen.
One of my wives is going to cook something.
Wow.
Listen, that's the... One of my wives is going to cook.
Wow.
Depends which one I want to submit to me that morning.
Yeah, I'm scared with you talking like that. You better not.
Isn't it scary? Isn't it? It's like, oh my God, you really think that? And you say that out loud to people? And somebody like hears that and goes, yes, this is what I've been missing my whole life.
I think they're tricking me and wanting to kill me. No.
Well, as we talked to Darren about the other day, naturally frying turkey.
Let's go.
Naturally.
That's what I like to hear.
Yeah, but they're not going to be around frying it.
No, we're going to a friend's house. But I think he says he's going to fry it at the house. So if he does, I'll let you know. Man. And you know, I don't deserve him.
You don't.
Well, we know.
We discuss this all the time. So I mentioned something about an outdoor heater. So he ordered one yesterday.
Stop.
It came in today.
Stop.
So we're going to be outside cooking all winter.
I want one.
We're going to put it together tomorrow probably.
Why not?
It's too much money.
It's not that much.
No.
It's like 200 or something.
No, it's like 110 on Walmart.
And Darren, you spent more or less.
Shut your face.
More on chickens.
You shut your face.
One thing about the trip. You want to know when I felt rich? We had a host that was just dedicated to us. He was like, yes, take my number down. I said, huh, take that, Darren.
Jeeves is here.
Yes, I'll take your WhatsApp. I felt rich, man.
You're
here.
Yes, but do you need anything? Nah, just checking on your salami. Anything good, man? You all right? It's kind of rainy last night, right? Anyways.
I'll talk to you later. TTYL.
Sleep tight.
And a heart. I should have did that.
I want to know how they would respond.
Word.
Yo.
Walk the other way when they see me.
But my brother always fries a turkey too the night before Thanksgiving.
Ooh.
So I'm going to his house Wednesday night, and then Thursday we're gonna just do Thanksgiving at his friend's house with we're cooking. We're gonna cook again. We're gonna do some collard greens.
Okay.
And the mashed potatoes, some beans. It's gonna be fun.
Regular old Negro Thanksgiving and all, you know. No big deal.
Something like.
I love that. Love it. Oh, man.
So he's awesome.
And then after that, there's a reunion going on.
Oh, yes. Yeah. That.
What's wrong with Jen?
I don't. Did you buy a ticket?
I can't make it because the boy's here.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. So. Sorry. But you in there. You in there, though.
Yeah, something like that.
Maybe. You going to be?
Maybe. Maybe.
Oh, we don't know.
Yeah.
All right, well,
Yeah, you weren't here last week.
Nah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, our 20-year reunion. Hey.
20 years.
I'm going to guess it's Darren who tried to put when we started high school on the Facebook today because I got a notification. Oh, please delete this.
Oh, that was me.
Oh, it was you.
Because I noticed our bio area is kind of like not the greatest bio. So I changed that. And
but then you put January 1998. I'm like,
that's. I didn't put January. I just put 1998. I think they defaulted that.
Well, it was 97. So.
It wasn't 98?
Nope, 97. September.
And I yelled at Darren out loud, not in front of him. For no reason, because it was you.
It was me.
I assumed it was him because, you know, he makes the typos.
Yeah. I make so many typos.
Yeah, I was being lazy. I was like, I don't need the month. Just da da da. Yeah.
I'm like, everybody knows we start school in September.
Did you fix it?
No, I couldn't. I tried.
Oh, all right. I'll fix it. But yeah, 20 years, man.
But Friday night, even though I'm not going to the reunion, I am trying to get together with some of the people.
So. Yay.
Well, I might be free in the evening.
Yeah, so we'll
let me know.
Yeah,
and we'll link.
And Lena's Litos. She's doing some orders for Thanksgiving. If you want some Thanksgiving Litos, you might want to hurry up and do that like now.
Like,
did she post anything?
Yeah, she did. And I meant to repost it and I forgot. But yeah.
Please, man.
She did. She's doing Thanksgiving orders. Also, her birthday's on Saturday.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Orders. Lena, you know I love you like with the love
is
of the Lord.
Is she making Litos? All right, that's all that matters.
That's all that matters.
Through pregnancy, your birthday, it doesn't matter.
Wow.
Anything. Ramadan. Anything. Try to order right now.
Yeah, you do that.
Shout
out to Boo Boo for winning his fight.
Yes.
And Kaylee also won her fight.
Indeed. Y'all don't know this person, but another female boxer, Alicia Bumgarner, she won, and she actually won a WBO title. There's a lot of black excellence. And also Canelo Alvarez, he had his fight. Against Jacob Plant, 2 weeks ago, and he won. So now Canelo.
Is he gonna finally fight Boo Boo?
And that's where I was going. So Canelo is what he's doing is he's going through and pretty much winning any belt in any weight class that he can get into, and he's killing it, and he's looking very unbeatable. Mm. So he's actually trying to go up a weight class to cruiserweight to take that title now. Mm. But everybody, I always check the comments to see what the idiots are saying because I want to see how many people actually mention Boo Boo. So there are a good amount of people that say, yo, what's up with Andrade? He has a title. Why aren't you fighting somebody with a title in your original weight class? Mm. So hopefully, because I was saying to somebody, in order for eyes to be on Boo Boo, he needs to win this fight in a convincing way. He needs a knockout. And he ended up winning the second round TKO or a knockout. I can't remember. So now they're saying it'll either be Triple G. The Charlo brothers. Mm. So they're going to, hopefully they can make that happen. And that will be the path to hopefully a Canelo fight. But I'm excited. Combat sports all day.
I'm also excited about the NFL.
Oh, here she goes. I saw you post it and I saw you thank my team.
I thanked your team. I thanked them early. First series of the first quarter, I said, let's go Bims Colts.
Come on now.
Because I'm like, I was watching the pregame shows. Well, if anyone doesn't know what I'm talking about, the Patriots are somehow first place in the AFC East.
I mean, somehow. You got the Jets. It was only the Bills that really messing with you.
Normally, we usually are a shoo-in.
It's a bad division.
We're usually a shoo-in for it. But every season, the Bills start out hot. The Dolphins kind of start out hot. And then they always fizzle out.
Yeah.
But the Bills have a squad. And the Patriots didn't. I mean, we didn't have really a quarterback. We have this rookie. We had the Cam Newton thing, blah, blah, blah. Which also, shout out to Cam for going back to the Panthers.
Back home.
You know, and getting back on a squad. Good for
looking
him.
Looking all right.
Good for him. Love Cam. So it was basically kind of like, okay, we knew we would need a few years to rebuild and all that. And the first few games, it was a lot of... I kept saying, I'm like, yo, they look solid, but they're making mistakes.
Right.
They're making mistakes that if they could just... correct those couple of things here and there, they could have won. The four games they lost, they could have won at least three of them, had barring a couple of plays.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, cool. So, the Patriots are now 7-4 at the top of the division. And it's exciting because we still haven't played the Bills. We still have two games against the Bills. So, the end of the season is going to be pretty fun for the AFC East, no matter who comes out on top. And your team, the Colts, beat the Bills. Your running back...
Yo,
beast
MVP candidate. He's getting busy. And me and my wife, who's excited to go to another Colts game, by the way. God, you have blessed me.
You're
so
blessed.
If I will get down and just... Yay. Anyways.
Hold your foot.
We went to the game, the opening, the season opener against the Seahawks. And they beat us pretty bad. Now the Seahawks are like 3-6.
They are. It's crazy. It may be 3-7 now.
Yeah.
Because they lost.
And we're, what, 6-5. That's so nuts. What a turnaround. Russell. Sorry. And
One two-step.
That's mean. You did it. Darren did it. He buried some chicken bones for me and, you know, took care. So the season has been like crazy.
It's
like
fun things to watch.
It's actually fun.
It's fun to watch.
Oh, I love it. I love it. And it's not like, not to knock the Patriots of the past, but I hated them because it was, okay, Tom and who?
Here we go.
But yeah. Now it's kind of like, it's anybody's.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so fun.
Like I said, I was watching a pregame show on CBS. And so what they did this week that just passed, they were like, okay, they, you know, every year the commentators will have their Super Bowl picks. And so they replayed their Super Bowl picks and were like, okay, does anybody want to change theirs? So a couple of guys kept them as they had it. It was like basically Green Bay, Tampa Bay, yep. Bills, Steelers, I think, a couple of the teams that were thrown in there. And I think maybe Phil Simms changed his to New England and Dallas.
Stop.
Which is kind of crazy to me.
Stop.
I mean, they're balling, but damn, Super Bowl. I can say that because I'm a Patriots fan. You're right. Always supposed to say the Patriots go to Super Bowl because you're Patriots fan. Right. That's how we are. But.
Stop. But making the playoffs is a huge win for the
huge
season.
Huge accomplishment. That's all we wanted. Like, yo, if we could just make it to over 50% of the games won, it's a successful season. But I'm like, yo, if the football gods was like, yo, let's do a Tampa Bay, New England Super Bowl.
Everything will break. Everything will break.
Internet broke.
Are you kidding
me? TV broke. Radio broke.
What? And you're going to be mad at me for saying this. And Dr. Dre halftime? Okay, you must see TV.
I was thinking about that.
Oh, my God.
I was like, the prices for the tickets would be...
Forget about
insane.
It. Forget about it. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. That's crazy.
Because the game we played... I mean, it was only like a 2-point game.
It was torrential downpour.
Down to the last minute.
Yeah.
They gave Tom Brady too much time in the last minute to get 2 points.
Yeah. Oof. Oh, that'd be fire. Season's been fun, though. It's been fun. NBA's been fun.
Oh, yeah. LeBron's been suspended for the first time in his career.
Before you move, speaking of football in high school, shout out to Classico, Division II champions.
Let's go. Football team doing the thing.
Go Purple.
So dope to see Mr. Bard there, too. Principal Bard in the picture.
You're so cool.
So strange.
Yeah. But you're so cool.
So weird.
Okay. NBA?
Oh, no. Yeah. Just, NBA season been crazy. Steph's been going berserk. Mm-hmm. Berserk. I think.
Katie's ashy.
Okay. Kevin Durant, sir. I saw him in person before he went into the NBA. It was right before he got drafted. We were in D.C. Club Love. It's not there anymore or something else now. But. Nobody around him, just this lanky guy with his shirt buttoned all the way to the top, just kind of looking around. And now, to me at least, the best player in the world. But somehow can't figure out how to work a brush or use lotion. Darren, you know when I tease you about your ashy ankles? It was worse than that.
Wow. Is that the thing I've... Oh.
We didn't know what it was when you looked at it, right?
I didn't.
Kind of looked like reptilian a little bit.
It did look like snake skin.
Yeah. It was just skin.
And I was like, wow.
Yeah.
I said, man, I'd be bad, but.
And that's why that picture was right
that,
there.
That's painful. No, because I'm thinking like especially now it's cold. Like, that would stop me in my tracks and me go back in the house and put some Vaseline on. Like,
not Vaseline.
And then his tweet's like, yo, don't make me start calling y'all broke.
What?
And that's your rebuttal. You calling us broke, but the $4 bottle of lotion you were avoiding like the plague. Bastard.
Because he's playing ball, yo.
What'd that mean?
He busy.
No, you're not busy.
When he takes his socks off, there's like an indent print of like in the ash that he's like, that doesn't feel good. Coming from somebody who knows ashy, that doesn't feel good.
And for anybody who's been in an argument before, when that person goes to money talk or calls somebody broke,
you lost.
You lost the argument.
You lost.
Just laugh at it and say, you know, I forgot my lotion. Yeah. Or I missed this leg. And that's why that picture exists. It's disgusting.
I love the memes. It's
brush
so
your
good.
Hair. Use so your lotion. Good. You're a millionaire. So multi-millionaire.
Good. I don't have to put lotion on. What the fuck?
So you're the best player in the world. You're just going to be all raggedy?
Who cares? I don't give a fuck.
It's nasty. It's nasty.
Sorry, I didn't mean to swear.
What kind of example are you? But mom, Kevin Durant does have the lotion.
My mom would definitely like pull me aside after the game. Like,
yo, my mom to this day, if I go in the house and go see her, I'm like, hey, mom, blah, blah. put some lotion on your face. If you don't get the hell out of here, you should put some lotion on your face.
It's so dry.
And it's out of love.
Yeah.
Because they want you going out there looking crazy.
They want you to look your best.
Like, fam, I'm wearing a mask. Who cares what my face looks like?
Who cares what my face looks
like? When I go pick, my mother picks up Kaiser for us on the week. During the week, and I'll go there, and she'll be like, "Hi, baby," and then she'll like, "Yeah, your toenails are too long. Your fingernails are too long. Come, let me cut them." And look, you need to do something with your hair. And I'm like, "All right, mommy. Like, yes,
it's love.
It's out of love.
It's love." I saw Yemi's nephew when we went.
Shout out to Yemi.
Yam, I love you, man. We went to a, and he's gonna remember this. We went to a Paw Sox game when they were still a thing in Rhode Island, and he came out the car, and I said, "Everybody, stop." He was wearing shorts, and underneath it looked like he was doing windmills in a Pot of Donut factory. Legs it was bad.
Legs look like a roadmap.
It was really bad, and I couldn't help. Usually, if there's a little ash in between my fingers, I put some lotion, some Carmex in between. I had nothing to solve that one. So I said, "What can we even do?"
Hey, man, you got to know your weakness. I keep a bottle of lotion in the car.
Smart.
I know me.
Damn.
I want to walk into a client site like, "Hey, good morning.
Hey, shake your hand. Hey, is everything okay? You got like a skin thing or something?"
I do.
They got that plaque psoriasis commercial. They start playing it.
I have really bad eczema.
So I saw this meme that I put on my story earlier, and I just think it's funny.
Let's go.
Nigga says strippers slam their coochie on the ground like a bag of ice.
Wow. Say again?
Okay. Nigga says strippers slam their coochie on the ground like a bag of ice. Oh,
it is true.
I can't see it.
Have more care. Have more care.
Come down straight from that pole.
Boom! And then we'll repeatedly. You're a woman.
Mm-hmm.
You can't feel that, obviously, right? That doesn't feel like
anything?
I don't
have the ability to even do the slam part.
Okay, gotcha.
So I don't know.
Okay.
But like, I assume it's like kind of protected. Like, it's not it hitting the floor.
It's like not like our nuts just constantly.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
That's... Yeah, you got the, yeah.
Because it's kind of in there. And
yeah, okay.
So this is hitting the ground.
That didn't even look fun.
Thigh. It doesn't, there's a lot of things I could not do because I'm worried about how it's going to affect my body.
Yeah.
And that's one of them.
Hmm. Even seeing them do it, I'm like, "You okay? Is it okay?
You want to talk about it?
You don't got to do all of that for a couple of dollars." But,
yeah, I mean, just gently slide down.
Right?
That's fine. The female gender is a constant mystery for me.
We're always learning.
Always learning. I didn't think we were going to get there, but here it is.
Well, you took us there.
Today I learned that there is a difference in women between horny and ovulation horny.
Yes.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, very different.
And so, I see it on TikTok. It's a funny little meme.
Stay off TikTok, Darren. No,
I can't. I try to take his phone. He won't give it to me.
No, I won't. I can't. Right?
It's meant for us.
And so, they had a little sound bite, and it's a woman saying that. And then she goes, "Because I'm ovulation horny, my coochie be like." And then they make like her pants like, rah, 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 like something like that. So, of course, I see this, and I like chuckle, and I go, I don't know anything about this. Wife, is there a difference? And, of course, she has to break it down for me like I'm a two-year-old. And I'm like, oh.
Because you ask like a two-year-old.
But there's no other way for you to know unless you ask.
Unless I ask.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We're not supposed to. I mean, I wasn't supposed to know that.
Yeah. But it does, knowing that does help us differentiate, right?
It does.
Because sometimes the turn-up is a different turn-up.
It is.
They're like, hey,
are you all right?
Everything okay? Like, okay. Yeah.
I mean, not that I'm complaining, but...
Right, but it's just, hey, man, this is different than...
Because you can't expect that every time.
Right.
That! You see? That, Jen. That's exactly what I took away from that conversation. Because I was like, yo, is that why sometimes... It's one way, and then when I go back for like
that?
Seconds, like the next day, it's like, no, it's gone.
You're like, yo, where's the lady who made the coffee last time?
That.
Because I'm not getting the same coffee.
Yeah. That's exactly what it is. Because it's like,
yeah, this is eye-opening.
Oh, put your leg down? Like, right. Okay.
Oh, you don't want me to bend you like that. Oh, you're mad now.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
They ain't teach us that in a health class.
They didn't.
So if we don't ask, we don't know. You know what I'm saying? I like it. I'm happy to be back. Honestly. Besides the stupid weather and like the government and fake money and all that other stuff, I'm really happy to see you guys. if I'm being honest.
That's like 80% of life.
Oh, man.
If you guys are going to play games this Thanksgiving, if you're going to be around family, I think, Jen, you talk about
these. You talk about
yeah. Get the game Incoherent.
Is it an app or like
no,
a board
it's
game?
No, it's a word game. It's like okay. almost like Taboo, if you will. So you played Taboo before.
I love Taboo.
Okay, so this is you have a category and you get a card, and the card will give you like kind of like a random words that you have to say out loud. And they don't seem like they make sense, but you put them together and you have to kind of keep saying them, and they're saying a phrase. They're spelling out a phrase.
Okay.
And that you have to kind of decipher. I can't think of any examples, but it'll be like really off-brand words. Like, let's say it's like the phrase is, it's 5 o'clock somewhere. Mm-hmm. So the words would be like, loosh something, like, it'll sound...
And you have to keep saying, it until it sounds like the phrase. Almost like elephant shoe.
Yes.
Elephant shoe.
Yes. I love you. Gotcha. Yeah.
Okay.
Like that. So the reason why I say get it, and this is anybody who's listening, if you get the game, make sure you play it with like a family member that was born in another country.
Oh, that's my wife.
Still has a heavy accent.
Yeah, my wife would not do well with this game.
Oh, man.
She would not do well.
Again, at Mushi's, we're playing one of our friends. He has still has a very strong
call him out.
Haitian accent. What up, Roland?
Is that
right? And you've probably met him. Okay. And he was destroying the night single-handedly. Oh. To the point we were like, leave. Like, go home. We want no more. You know, the thing is, right, because it makes you recognize, like, the strengths and weaknesses of people from your country, right? So, like, for me, I recognize how loud Haitians get for no reason. Like, let's say the first word was, like, sores in triangle, something like that, right? Mm-hmm. So we're like, okay, they're like, okay, everybody, like, read the word to yourself, right? One, Haitians don't know how to read things to themselves. They have to read it out loud. And two, Haitians out loud. So literally, he's like, Saws! Saws, look! And all of us are like, why is he so loud? Right? But we're all cool with each other, so we're like calling him out, like, Roland, turn it down. He's like, what? That's a Saws bean! Saws! Saws, and the more he's going, the more we're melting down. So, I want to buy this game and play with my dad. Like, that's what I want to do.
You just want to cause problems.
I want to say, he likes trouble.
Every problem I could possibly find.
Don't do this to your dad.
I want to gather like a pile of leaves. And okay, Claudia.
That's mean.
Oh, that's so mean.
But he would love it.
He would.
Yeah.
So you guys didn't own the game. It was
no. Somebody else brought it.
Huh. I'd like to see about that. Yeah, I just pulled it up.
It was, good.
Okay.
Very good game. It was very fun.
Who won? Oh, did you guys just give up?
We didn't get there because he was killing us. Oh, I just have one other question. But.
Oh.
Go ahead.
Do you have a secret talent?
Well, if she told us.
It wouldn't be a secret. But I guess a not well-known talent to yourself.
I don't think of myself as talented, so no.
I hate you. Jen. We do the math thing every other episode.
Yeah, but that's not a secret talent. Everybody knows about
that. Okay, so
forget the secret thing. You are talented.
What is your superhero talent?
I could do math.
There you go.
That was just anticlimactic.
Because I knew she was going to do that stupid thing and say, no, nothing. I'm a nobody. I'm a nobody.
Little shrug.
I like solving problems.
You're a problem solver?
Yeah, sure.
She's a problem solver.
She downplays herself, and she's brilliant.
You know who else downplays himself?
Not
Darren.
Me. I was looking at him like, please don't point to me. Please don't point. That's my talent.
You know who else downplays himself?
If we worked to our potential, this podcast would be
amazing. But instead,
there's like 7 people who listen to us every week. We thank you. We hope you enjoy. Secret that only you have.
Right.
This is our secret talent.
This is our secret talent.
Boom. Boom, and it is a secret.
Being mediocre at this podcast.
No, the
we're not mediocre,
is great.
So you did it again.
The podcast is great. We're mediocre at promoting it.
There you go.
Okay.
I got yelled at again. 401k karaoke. Hopefully you guys were there. You already heard this. Oh, actually, you got a day.
I was going to bring that up.
And I'm mediocre at promoting anything. I get yelled at by them.
You did pretty good.
I did?
For them. To me, compared to other stuff.
Oh, my God.
I was like, what? Look at Ben posting this thing.
Because they yelled at me.
Because you didn't even tell us about it.
Nope. They yelled at me.
And we were like, what?
There was a conference call. They were yelling at me. I said, guys.
Have you met me?
I didn't even promote my engagement. I was supposed to tell people about the clothes. I told like 4 people. And then I got yelled at. And I was like, oh, maybe I guess I should tell Darren.
Did you hear us try to plug it the other day? We were like,
thank you for that.
Bim's doing a thing. We don't know about it, but here you go.
Yeah.
So what I was going to say is, we know we promised we would do karaoke in November.
And we lied.
And we did not.
We didn't.
Life got very busy in November.
Yes.
But Bim will be hosting a karaoke this Saturday.
This Saturday at Revival Brew House.
Brew House.
And I actually went there yesterday. Nice looking facility.
Hey.
It's where, the same owner as... Choop.
Oh.
Yeah. So
I just guessed. It just felt like it.
Yeah. And now it should be a good look. And it's very different than something that we would do. Very different. Mm-hmm. Like in terms of it's going to be like... games and stuff like that. We would never do that.
On Saturday? Stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll try this tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, I think you have to buy your thing ahead of time. You can't just pop up.
Eventbrite link in my Instagram bio. I even did that.
Wow.
And day of, you could just pull up. And at the door, you can sort it.
Oh, I thought you couldn't.
Yeah, you can pull up day of.
So, yeah, there's that.
But we are
going
to do...
We are going to do karaoke again.
Yes.
Hopefully very soon.
Yes, our very unpromoted karaoke event in December.
For the end of 2021.
Yes.
So keep your eye out. We know we promised November. It didn't happen.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But go to Revival Brew House on November 27th. Or if you're not into that, you can also go to...
our Instagram page for more updates.
No, that's not what I was going to say.
Oh, what were you going to say?
I was going to say When Stars Align, because we were supposed to host... But I thought our reunion was that day, and I feel like it got moved to Friday. I feel like it initially was on Saturday.
The reunion, right?
I feel like it was on Saturday.
I feel like it was Saturday, too.
It was initially Saturday.
Because I said it, and then I was like, no, I was told I was wrong, but I thought it was Saturday.
Yeah, so now it's on Friday, and now we could have done When Stars Align, so I'm pretty pissed off. But
yeah.
Still go to When Stars Align, Chip's dope-ass show. It is this Saturday.
It'll be at Fett, right?
I'm trying to make sure right now so I don't give the wrong information.
It's been so long since I've been to a Chip show.
Same.
I know, it's terrible. So we should pull up since we're not. It is going to be at Fett Providence Saturday, 11:27. Art, fashion, music, dance. He's got a bunch of dope-ass artists and...
a gaggle of artists.
Whatnot, what have you, going to be there.
Now, with Troop, I know I heard before that they required negative...
Me, Fett?
Fett, sorry. I know I saw that they were requiring negative COVID tests or vaccination card. Was that mentioned anywhere in the post? Okay. Yeah, I just wouldn't want people to get there and not be able to get in for some reason.
Well, it's $10 in advance. Price will be higher at the door. If you want more information, follow @Chip_Doug on Instagram and you'll get more information. He's got the people performing, the artists bringing their art, etc., etc.
Miss it.
I know. And the last time you were,
I didn't have a leg.
I know you had no leg to stand on, and me and Darren had to go carry the interviewing process.
Why am I always messing stuff up?
That was
always me.
No, this time it's Darren because he wanted to go DJ the reunion.
I also told you that wasn't a thing anymore.
Yeah, but that we already told Chip no, guy. We told Chip no.
I know. This was after the
fact. Yeah, but maybe we should still
look. Yeah,
we'll see how that works out on Saturday.
The reason I bring up the secret, I'm sorry to go back to the secret talent part.
But, oh, yes.
Because Aaron's going to tell us he can do a pretzel with his
teeth. And a backflip.
while doing the pretzel. We play the game where you take a fruit roll-up and you have to eat it. Like, have you ever seen that game?
Fruit roll-up.
No, like, who could do it faster?
Silly. So, I can't eat a fruit roll-up.
That's no secret. Silly. So Mushi came up with all these games. So it's boys against girls. And so we all line up and we did like this relay race. So you have to take the fruit roll-up, put it in your mouth, and your mom said go. And you have to, but
no
hands.
Yes, okay.
Yeah, right. So we're doing it. And so we're going and the girls are winning. Right,
I would think the guys would have an advantage.
You would think, but the girls were just killing it, right?
We wouldn't be eating, bro. You seen them? They be eating, bro. Oh, shit. Go
ahead. Wife was killing it. A couple other women. So it came down to me and Mushi, right?
Mm.
Mushi goes, and she has like a good 20-second head start.
Oh, damn.
My secret talent kicked in, which I did not know. I felt I didn't feel good. Like, I wasn't proud of myself on how well I did. Let me just put that out. Everything was working together. Unison. I was like shoving it in and yeah. My head was doing a bunch of stuff that I was like, this doesn't feel good.
A lot of this.
Yes. I beat her. I ended up winning for the whole team. I felt so good about myself. Not good about what I actually had to do.
I know somebody recorded you.
Thankfully, no.
Oh, good. That's the kind of game that I like. Mm-hmm. Just us, no, man. No poof.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, amazing.
No glizzies. No.
Hey, yo, I know Thanksgiving's over by the time you hear this, but thank you, Darren. I hope you are not that person who sent out, hey, stranger, happy Thanksgiving texts.
That's the thing?
I kind of want to do it now.
Uh-oh.
No,
no, you don't.
I don't, but I just want to do it. Just
no, don't.
No, you don't.
I do.
No.
If you don't talk to the person the other days of the year, don't send a happy Thanksgiving text.
That's weird.
It's so annoying.
Yeah, if it's not somebody's birthday, just leave it alone.
I mean, I really don't like holiday texts, even from people that I do talk to.
Yeah,
like happy Thanksgiving, but from people that you don't talk to,
thank you.
It's just like,
That's strange.
Fam,
block that person.
Yeah, I've been blocked.
Hey.
If you're not talking to them now, just keep it that way. There's no reason for you to talk to them.
Yeah.
If they're not talking to you, then...
Happy Thanksgiving. That's going to be the spark fella. Get out of here.
Oh, man.
He really does think about me.
Right. Pass the gravy? No.
That reminds me of something very funny and awkward that happened on Thanksgiving. I'll tell you guys after.
I was going to say, I don't think this is something.
It's after pod worthy.
Shout out to Iman for winning Dance with the Stars.
Who's that? Iman Shumpert. Oh, I saw the thing he did, Us, mimicking the Us from the movie Us.
I still didn't watch the movie. I know we all planned as a pod to go to the theater. Remember that? I didn't go.
So that routine that he did.
Well, the one with the red where they were like.
Yeah.
Stinky. It means nothing to her.
So it, nothing.
It was nice.
Nice. Yeah.
But congrats to Iman Shumpert.
Congrats.
But he was a ringer.
Because he's married to Tiana and she's a dancer.
Amazing artist, dancer, everything.
And so, they probably dance at home.
Come on. Probably.
I mean, he was in that video with her with Kanye at the end.
Yeah, and one of Drina's friends was at a Tiana Taylor show a couple days ago, actually. Oh. And they were recording the stage because their daughter was in the back doing the moves.
Mm.
So, come on. He's a ringer. He's a ringer. But he got it. Congrats, man. Black excellence. Body that dance, though. Mm. Oh, man.
All the dances I've seen the little clips of. I'm like, all right.
Yeah. No, he's good.
So we would like to say thank you to all those who listen and rock with us, as they usually
always,
do.
Always, yo. I missed you, yo.
Been missing you.
All of yous. And if you don't want me back, just send us a message.
All of yous guys.
All of you guys is this. And if you don't want Ben back and you want more guests, send us a message. We'll bring more guests in. Honestly, I didn't want to come back so you guys could record with somebody else so I could listen to it.
No.
That's selfish.
Yeah.
Like the fat lady.
Yeah. Oh.
The one that killed her guy.
I know.
She's very selfish. Remember?
I remember.
The legs weren't green.
The legs were
so sad.
Go ahead. Probably thought they looked like hers because she got the veins.
Darren, keep going.
Make sure you follow us on Instagram. PLSDELTHIS on Twitter, the same handle.
25.
On Facebook, the Please Lead This Podcast. Make sure you follow us on YouTube. Search Please Lead This Podcast as well. Listen to us on your favorite streaming platforms, such as Spotify, Spreaker, iTunes Radio, iHeartRadio, and all that good stuff. We listen to podcasts. You can catch us Mondays on WBRU 101.1 FM with DJ Franchise and them. Shout out to them. They hold down the morning slot on Mondays and Tuesdays from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. And then DJ Matic at, I believe, at 11 playing Hot Ahsoka.
This guy's
and
good.
And then we come in on one and we totally ruin everything. No, we're really good.
We're really good.
We hold it down. So make sure you tune in to there if you're in Rhode Island. If you're not in Rhode Island and you want to listen, get the TuneIn app, search WBRU 360, or use the WBRU 360 app.
That's what I do.
Or WBRU.com.
Yes.
Shout out to them. They gave us some nice merch. What we got?
Yeah.
And they'll be selling some of that merch at When Stars Align on Saturday.
Yeah, it's with Chip Doug, Chip_DOUG.
I'm going to try to slide in there for real.
Me too.
Yeah.
Karaoke on Saturday with Brother Bim.
Shout out to BMF. I actually really like that show.
The show? Mm-hmm. Oh, look at you.
Yeah.
Okay.
We haven't watched the finale yet, but probably do that next
week. The finale's here already?
Yeah.
What's the 8 episodes?
It's 7.
Oh, my God. That's
weird. I want to shout out to Eric Kofi Abrefa, who is the guy who plays Lamar.
Yo.
That fellow.
Psycho.
That British fellow is...
He is British.
He is acting his whole arse off on...
You can't stop the rain.
Yo.
Oh, yeah, no, I kept hearing the memes about that.
Yo. Because, like, first you got to get rid of the accent. Right. And then you got to sing.
Right. Oh, man.
He bodied that character.
I forgot that he had an accent. Oh, boy.
Bodied. He's done an amazing job.
Mm.
Like, because when you see the clips of him on Instagram of his actual self, and he's, like, so happy and just African and British and, oh, I love and then, like, you see him on BMF and you're like, yo.
What type of disrespectful is she?
I don't know, man. You wouldn't even think she was African.
No, because he's, like, my brethren, right? Like, I'm right. Like, oh, this guy's so nice. Like, I could see him being at the table with us.
Oh, joyful, yes.
Jollof rice and joy. And then.
Flips a switch.
Amazing.
And becomes a psychopath.
Our good friend Vic Bam said he's like what Omar was to The Wire.
Yeah.
And I said, you know what?
And even with The Wire, Omar was feared, but he didn't give off that like unstable vibe. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? He kind of was like a Robin Hood. But this guy is just tapped. Yeah. Oh.
But then when you see his actual clips of him in real life, you're like, he's so smiling.
That's acting.
Acting his like. Wow. I mean, the show was good, but I think he really.
He's the bright spot in terms of acting.
He made that show. Yeah.
And Meech's mother.
She reminds me of kind of like Kerry Washington. Always got that look. Cryy okay. voice.
I got you.
Yeah. I can't be that mortgage.
You know why I like her though? And this is the nerd in me. She was on an episode of Family Matters. She was on the episode of Family Matters where Eddie was dating her. She was a nerd. And she kept buying him stuff. And she became more popular because she was dating Eddie. And she took all her stuff back. I never forgot that episode. And I saw it. And I said, that looked like her. And it's her. So, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
That reminds me of the chick who did that on Fresh Prince.
Yes. Yeah, did that to Will.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's true. Wow. Are they just recycling the same premises on black shows? Anyways.
Possibly. That's neither here nor there.
I haven't watched the most recent Insecure. But the season's been kind of starting a little slow, but it's moving.
It's different.
Yeah,
they got better cameras, but the directorial style is very different. Mm. Like they, I think they did other seasons too, but different director each season. Mm-hmm. Like Kerry Washington did the most recent one. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's different.
Yeah, because there was like one episode where Issa wasn't in the episode at all.
Yes.
And I didn't check if she directed that, but I noticed she just wasn't in the episode.
Yeah, I don't think she directed. I don't know if she directed any of the ones I've seen yet or any of the ones that premiered. But I finally saw the episode with the whole controversy with the sorority color stuff.
Yeah, you see it, right?
It's just the colors.
What is that? It was a cute-ass dress.
I'm burning the internet on my phone. I'm sick of everybody. I said, this is what the Wahala was about?
My brother. My brother.
My sister. I can't, man.
She can't wear pink and green.
I'm sick of people. Mm. Anyways. But yes, some good TV for the fall. They ramped up for the fall.
I've been catching up on Million Little Things. That show's still good.
Still crying.
No, not crying.
That's the one with...
With the suicide.
Oh, yeah, okay. I catch episodes here and there and... You ever watch a show and you're just like, this can't get worse. Like you, like mm-hmm. not even like the show can't get worse. Like you character can't. You, mm-hmm. What are you doing? Like you stop, mm-hmm. stop.
Mm-hmm. Network TV. Gary's
killing
me.
Gary's killing me. Like, Gary really makes me mad.
Gary was like is the coolest one on the show in my opinion.
Yeah.
Besides Romney.
Romney. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Gary's like the you have it. You have it mostly together.
Is he the one with the beard?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have a
beard already.
Yeah.
True.
Yeah.
True.
You have it mostly together. You.
And he just keeps doing.
What Gary did, y'all? What Gary did, y'all?
Gary done did it.
For no good reason. Oh, he Gary. Done did it.
Gary, he
lost a really good woman. Not even the
not even the therapist.
The kid.
Yeah.
For what? Because you were mad?
Hmm.
I mean, and then again, it's like a part of me is like, okay, I get it. You mad?
I get it.
But you couldn't protect yourself a little bit. Mask.
mask. It's COVID. You could have put it, you an excuse for a mask.
Bon, comme ça, comme ça. Eh bien, eh bien. Oh, oh. It's not Gary. No, no.
It's not Gary.
It's not Gary. No, no. It's not Gary.
It's a Mary.
Oh, my God. The wife watches the show. I'm going to go home and be like, yo, what Gary did, baby? Yo,
oh,
what Gary
did?
Yeah, I'm like, what Gary did?
High five her for me.
Yo, man, I don't.
She likes
all
that stuff.
I don't even
TV
watch
stuff.
It like habitually. Just, every time I walk in the room and she's watching, I'd be like, all right, here we go. Stupid ass Gary, yeah.
Stupid ass Gary. Boston Bruins.
What? The stupidness. And then you got the nerve to be sad. Ah, it's me and the dog again. Then you did this to yourself.
Is Gary self-sabotaging? Is
he definitely is self-sabotaging.
That dog didn't want no parts of that.
No part of it. Mm. There's no reason for it. I don't even know like how it ended. I just know the guy,
Darren's frustrated.
You lost a whole entire relationship.
Kind of like the baby and Danny Lay.
What happened there? My wife kept trying to tell me during the trip. I said, we on the island. I don't want to hear nothing about
Danny Lay. I don't
want to
hear none of that crap. I kind of heard a smidge of it.
Even me kind of. So Danny Lay and the baby were dating, I guess. And then she had a baby.
The baby.
The baby's baby. That's so great.
And I guess she went to his house. He's saying they're not together.
Yeah, for a while.
And he's trying to get, And she's like, no, we are together. So he's trying to get her out the house. So he starts recording on live because he's like, I'm trying to protect myself because I don't want it to come out that it's something else. I'm just trying to get her out of my house. Mm. But it looks bad because she's got your 3-month-old baby and you're
the baby was with her.
The baby was with her. She's like breastfeeding. It's like, oh, you're trying
not to... the baby, but the baby.
The baby's
the
baby.
Baby. Yes.
The baby.
The baby's baby.
The baby's
baby.
The
baby's baby.
Baby square.
The baby square.
I'm confused.
It's now you got this lady on live. I mean, I understand you're trying to protect yourself, but there's other ways you could have did that. Yeah. And she's like, you know, we were together, and he's like, not really. And it's just messy. And it's like you didn't have to put her online with the baby.
But then I get it, you're trying to protect.
But at the same time,
it's a tough spot because he was dealing with the other stuff.
He's dealing with the other stuff, and he's just now trying to get uncanceled from canceled. So he's like, you know what? I'm not gonna let y'all trick me and put me in a corner again. So look, I'm not doing nothing to her. I'm not touching her. Yeah. I'm just politely asking her to leave, and she's not leaving.
Yeah, it's a really tough spot to be in. And,
he's someone who can't get out of his own way.
Right, and it's tough because then if he doesn't record and then she go and tweet something or say something on her IG, then it's he says, she said, and he looked like a crazy guy. God forbid she says something like, oh, he kicked me out with my baby.
Right. And he's like, no, I just asked her to leave because she don't live here.
Nobody would believe it. So
and even with seeing it, that he's just asking her to leave because she don't live there. Yeah. It's like, and the whole thing sucks because a couple years ago, you know, Danny Lay was singing, her career was taking off. She was a Puma endorsed artist.
She has a great song with Chris Brown. I love that song.
And it feels like she kind of put her own career on the back burner in order to be his woman. And now he's like, but you weren't my woman.
Is that what she did? I hope not. Or did she think she like was cashing in and was like straight and didn't have to do nothing because she was winning? Because she should have just kept her. Because we saw Cardi pregnant doing stuff. Go ahead and keep
Offset,
grinding.
Offset was doing things, and she was like, you know what? If you want this.
Yeah.
And you know what I mean? So now you're saying, well, you're kicking me out of this place, and you're putting me on the street. But if you would have kept doing your thing, you would have had your own place, and it wouldn't matter.
Yeah, he don't owe you that. He just got to take care of his baby. The baby's baby.
The baby's
baby.
The baby square.
Yeah, baby square. Damn, that's sad, but I mean, whatever. Wrap it up, y'all. You gotta wear condom. Yaffe. That's the moral. Wear condom. And only have sex when you're married.
Yes.
It solves everything.
Does it?
For the most part.
Okay.
You'd be surprised.
I plan to never know that.
Which part? Because you're pregnant. I'm gonna say you're pregnant.
No, because I plan to never marry again.
You don't need to.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Man, you good.
Good.
Yeah, you did good.
You did great.
You did great, kid. You did great.
Second time's a charm.
Okay. See, I didn't do it this time.
It's all right.
Somebody got to do it every time.
It's quite all right.
At least he's been married. I've never been married.
Mm.
So he's got 2 to my 0. Mm. So it balances
it
out.
It evens out.
Mm. It averages.
Yeah. 0, 2 divided by 2
is 1.
Yeah. So... Yeah.
So between the 3 of us, 3 marriages divided by 3 people is 1. It balances out.
So we've all been married.
So Darren did it for
me. We've all been married once.
Wow. Darren did that, so he had to go through that.
Whoa. Whoa.
Hello. Whoa. Hello. Hello. Two podcasts don't nobody else care. Hello. It's a podcast, baby.
We here.
But I do want to get married.
Yeah. It's a beautiful
thing. Then it'll be 4/3.
Does our friend know? Mm-hmm. Now he knows.
He knows now.
I like this.
Him know now.
Him know now.
Him downstairs.
Shit.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving, y'all. Darren, let's get out of here, man.
Yeah. Happy Thanksgiving to you and yours. Enjoy the holiday with friends
Welcome
and family.
Back,
and if you do not have friends and family, enjoy it with us somehow.
We're your friends.
Yes,
we're your family.
Us. Yes.
We're all of that. and surprise, we record on Tuesday. So if something happened.
Wednesday, Thursday.
Sorry.
We all know about it.
You tell us about it.
Yes.
We'll talk about it next week, maybe.
Thanksgiving song.
Happy to be back, guys.
I know. I was thinking. I was like, you wouldn't have a Thanksgiving song this year.
We had a song?
Yeah.
What was the song last year?
Not last year. Song
I'm
yet.
Thankful.
Could that just be our song?
I guess so.
All right. So we're going to sing it?
You got it, because that's your song.
I'm mad I brought it up because I don't want to sing it.
You see, you create your own problem.
Story of his marriage.
Story.
Oh, dear.
I'm thankful for everything now.
I'm thankful for everything now. I'm thankful for everything now. Really
Later.
Peace.